Coming to you live from Stuart, Florida, the greatest little town in the world. It's the Get Up and Go Show on AM 1450 WSTU. You're invited to call the show anytime at 772-220-9788. And now, broadcasting live from their palatial studios, here are your hosts, Evan and Bonnie.
6:07 on the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie. We're a blended show this morning.
You want to be like me, a love guy, the kind of guy women love to be with on a date.
Well, yeah, I would love to be like you. I admire you.
You're completely disgusting, you know that?
Well, no, I'm not disgusting.
You people ready to have some fun?
Yeah, we're going to have a lot of fun this morning. I definitely think so on the program. And we welcome you in. That is the Get Up and Go Show band. They're here bright and early this morning in the green room with Fredo and the Shy Guys. Bonnie, top of the morning to you.
Good morning to you, Evan.
How you doing?
I'm doing well this morning. Well, on a Tuesday, it's a chillier note if you step outside. So wear a jacket, wear a sweater.
Mm-hmm.
I have my pink sweatshirt on from Victoria's Secret that I love to wear.
Oh, I thought you said pink. I'm like, that's maroon to me.
I know.
But it says pink on the front.
Yeah, I really like the brand. Hey, you know what, Evan?
What?
Right on a top note, I just want to verify a
not
story.
Not a bottom note, but a top note.
That we had on the news yesterday. We had one of the beautiful Tanya Roberts, the James Bond girl.
Yeah.
From A View to a Kill. And
Bond.
She played in that 70s show. Tanya Roberts, we learned today, there are reports out that she really didn't die.
Really?
Yeah.
No kidding.
So we had the story yesterday, and it looks like her publicist, Mike Pingle, had told the Associated Press on Monday that Roberts, age 65, was still alive as of 10 a.m. yesterday morning, but in poor condition.
Oh, wow.
So,
fake news.
But they
fake
they,
news.
All kinds of media, you know, yesterday, including ourselves, we had, you know, mistakenly reported her dead as the reports came out.
Okay.
So we're going to just have to kind of keep following the story and looking at her, following her condition and her whereabouts. And I know I was reading that Ashton Kutcher and all of
I love the way you say that. Kutcher.
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 If I
Ashton
say
Kushner.
It right. all of the kids from that 70s show, of course, have been praying for her and to find out, she's really alive.
Okay, well, that's a good thing. We don't want to see anybody drop dead.
And I was surprised when, I saw her in the news. I think she had been out, like, walking her dogs. She had fallen or something, taken in, and reports came out that she was deceased and apparently not.
You know, I could use a good belly laugh this morning. So if anybody wants to call this morning and tell us a good joke, and we feel your joke is worthy, we'll give you a $20 gift certificate to Ellie's Downtown Deli.
Nice.
I'm being generous this morning. Right off the bat, nice and early. So if James or anybody else wants a call, 220-9788. We're a blended show this morning, so you're listening to us also on our sister station, WPSL, AM 1590, the Talk of the Treasure Coast. G and Ray are on vacation this week. Or should I say a mental sabbatical, so to speak. They're getting recharged and coming back with an all-new show in the new year. So if you would like to partake in our program this morning and think that you have a funny joke, we welcome your phone call, 220-9788. Give our palatial studios a phone call. If we think your joke is funny, we'll give you a $20 gift certificate to Ellie's Downtown Deli. How
and
about that, Bonnie?
That's great. And wouldn't you love to get a hot bowl of soup on a day like today?
Yeah.
Feeling that chill in the air.
And definitely.
Chef Mark later this morning will be preparing two new soup flavors.
Mm, boy, sounds
and
good.
He puts all of the best ingredients into the soups, you know. And
he truly does.
Freshly made with everything he makes.
He truly does. So, Bonnie, you used your Christmas present for the first time yesterday. I want to hear about your experience with the Ninja Foodie Grill, because, you know, I've been talking about it forever and a day on the show. And, you know, every time I talk about it, your eyes just perk up. So you and Gary decided you're going to treat yourselves to a Christmas present, and you got one.
We did, and I'm so happy to have this nice, modern piece of beautiful technology in my kitchen, Evan.
Mm-hmm.
And it's quality. You know, you use it for the first time.
Right.
And
how was it when you opened the box and, and you know, you cut open the tape and the box opened up and here you have this beautiful shining black and silver piece of state-of-the-art electronic technology.
Yes.
That does wonders with food. It was like, when you open the box, did the sun rays come out of it like you see on TV?
It was like, hallelujah.
Right?
But no, I opened the box rather carefully to make sure I had all the pieces and I didn't have pieces flying everywhere.
Right.
But the directions of the idea is just kind of like to take everything out slowly, untape, unravel, and
read. And then you got it out of the box and on the counter, and, and then this happened. Right? That's exactly what happened.
Well, at first, that didn't happen. You have to be careful because you know what I did at first?
Oh, no.
You know how that bottom part, the cooking tray, the pot, okay, the pot goes in first.
The pot that always stays in there.
And the instructions when you cook. State to how to place it in the groove that's in the back. So
right.
It puts
Please don't tell me you did
properly.
It backwards.
I didn't do it. Backwards
you didn't
with
do
that
it at
one.
All?
However, I did it backwards upon putting the grill in.
Oh, no. And then it wedged in there.
It wedged in there.
And you couldn't get it out.
Yeah.
Oh, no. What did Gary do? Did he get a hammer or pliers or something?
No, I came in and, you know, sat down and put my hands on my head. I sat on the couch frustrated, trying to get it out and wedge the piece out of there.
Right.
I was able to bring the pot with the grill right over to the couch. And I'm
right.
Prying, pulling it out. It came out.
Finally did.
Yeah.
Oh, boy. I bet you won't do that again.
You got to be careful about putting it in properly. You got to wedge the back groove in with the back groove, and you got to do so with the grill.
So then when you got it unwedged, then you did.
Hallelujah.
Right? Yeah. That's exactly what you did.
Because I pulled out that wedgie.
Okay.
You got to be careful.
The Ninja Foodie had a wedgie going on. Okay.
But, man, the steaks were terrific.
Yeah?
Like no other steak I've had in a while.
Right?
Yeah.
Sure beats going out, putting the charcoal out there outside, huh?
It did. You know, and I was going to be lazy about it and actually fire up the backyard grill and the charcoal and, you know, until I really learn how to do this thing.
Oh, you can kick that thing to the curb now. You won't be grilling on that thing anymore.
Well, I don't know. I still like to be
out.
Wait,
you put a couple of hot dogs in there.
Yeah.
Put a couple of hot dogs in the Ninja Foodie where you cooked your steak last night. And, man, they'll come out really good.
Now,
they'll have the grill marks on there and everything.
Oh, I bet that's good. And I bet with the hot dogs, you only have to do it for, what, 2 minutes?
Oh,
if
just
that?
A couple of minutes.
Yes.
Yeah.
You'll have a great afternoon lunch in no time.
You have a roasted weenie real quick.
I've been, like, serving up some really good items lately.
Mm-hmm.
Made hamburgers the other night, but I just broiled them in the oven, right?
Okay, you cook those in there too?
But
instead of broiling them in the oven, you put them right there on the Ninja Foodie.
And the idea about, you know, making a good hamburger lately is the bread and the bun. The
now,
buns
do you get the frozen patties, or do you buy the chopped meat and you make the hamburger patty from scratch?
Exactly.
Which way?
Like you said, the chopped meat and the hamburger patty from scratch.
Okay, so you get in there and you just mush it down
mash
like
it,
this.
Mush it,
mash it, form it, make it round,
all
nice and
meat.
Big and hard, and you stick it in the grill and you let it go.
That's right. You make it to the size that you want.
Okay, now do you use breadcrumbs?
No.
Okay. Here's a little secret. Next time that you are going to make some hamburgers, okay, crack an egg, mix in one egg with the hamburger meat. The reason you're doing the egg is because the egg will hold the chopped meat together along with the breadcrumbs.
Ooh.
When you're making, and make sure and get Italian breadcrumbs.
Almost sounds like making a meatloaf.
Very similar, except instead of forming it into a meatloaf, you're forming it into a hamburger.
Uh-huh.
Same exact concept.
I bet it's very good.
The breadcrumbs and the egg will keep the burger together. Because you ever notice, Bonnie, when you cook a regular homemade burger and you take the chopped meat by itself and you cook it on the grill, it kind of falls apart
sometimes
on the
sometimes it
sides.
Wants to fall apart
right.
on you,
well,
yeah.
Well, when you put the breadcrumbs in there along with the egg, it's not going to fall apart.
You would think the egg would make it mushier and gooier where it would fall apart.
No, because when you cook an egg and the egg is in the frying pan, it's all slimy and nasty.
Yeah.
But then once it cooks, it becomes hard. So that's the same thing it does in the premise of the chopped meat. It's mixed in with the chopped meat, so it gets hard, and it keeps the chopped meat together.
Okay. Hey, Evan, could I fry
I feel like a culinary
could
chef.
Could I fry an egg in my Ninja Foodie Grill too if I wanted? You gotta make eggs or pancakes or anything with that?
No, that you cannot do, unfortunately. Can't do that in there because you only have the air fryer basket, the air crisper basket, and then you have the grill section that allows you to grill things.
Okay.
And in the air fryer basket section, that's where you do your air frying of your chicken wings, your french fries, tater tots, onion rings, and then also you can dehydrate food in there as well.
I have another important question.
Sure, ask away.
So, like with my steaks last night,
right?
I spread vegetable oil around the steak area. Mm. As the directions from the Ninja Foodie said.
Okay.
I don't know, not required.
You don't need to. No, not required at all.
Okay, so say if I'm, okay, I have a recipe for pork chops where I call it peanut butter pork chops.
Oh, okay.
I mix peanut butter up with like a soy sauce or a Worcestershire sauce.
Mm-hmm.
I mix that all up, ooey and gooey, and then I baste my pork chops in it.
Okay.
Can I include that in the Ninja Foodie with a pork or a peanut butter based?
Sure, you can. You can bake your pork chops in the Ninja Foodie because you have the air crisper. There is a bake mode and there's a broil mode. So you do it in the bake mode, and for the bake mode, you keep the metal grill in there that you would cook your steak on as well, but you're baking instead of broiling.
Yeah.
And your pork chops are going to swell up, I will tell you that much. Or if you put
plump.
A chicken breast, yeah, they get nice and plump in
That's
there.
All right.
Yeah.
I mean, it's my steaks looked nice.
What kind of steaks?
Juicy and plump. Ribeye.
Ribeyes.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Bone in or bone out?
Bone in.
Oh, nice.
Oh, it was good.
Very nice.
I mean, it was the juiciest steak ever.
It really is. It really, truly is because it keeps the juices in.
And the Ninja Foodie Grill, I mean, we just did a whole commercial for them.
I know, right?
Right now.
They should send us one.
I would recommend it.
Yeah.
I mean, it's...
See, we're official spokespeople now for the Ninja Foodie.
And it looks nice in your kitchen.
It does. It sits right on the counter with your other appliances.
The black and the silver.
Silver, yeah.
The stainless steel. And
for sure.
It goes with everything.
For sure. As they say, for shizzle. There you go.
I'm for shizzle now.
I'm glad you like it, though. I really am. I'm glad you finally... you took that step and you got it, and now you've been Ninja Foodie-ized.
And now it's time to maybe get a membership at BJ's once again or Sam's Club.
Either one of the places.
Gotta stock up.
And stock up on your food. And, you know, we have a freezer full of chicken and steak and pork chops and all that. And once I'm done with my diet food, I'm going to go back and start cooking again in the Ninja Foodie. The wife cooked a couple of steaks in there the other night while I was watching TV, and I was like, you really had to do that, didn't you?
Oh, boy.
Oh, man. It was good.
But the steak is protein. I think with your diet, you probably could do a good one once in a while.
Yeah, I mean, right? I do a protein shake every day.
Yeah.
So, you know, where I miss my protein, I make it up in my protein shake for sure. 620 on a blended show this morning. G and Ray on vacation. They'll be back next week. Let's go to the news desk where Bonnie's standing by. Good morning, Bonnie.
Good morning, Evan. And two local members of Congress are challenging the election of President-elect Joe Biden, joining more than 100 Republicans who are casting doubt over the results. This despite state and federal courts, state election officials and federal officials rejecting accusations of widespread fraud in the November 3 election. Representatives Bill Posey and Brian Mast represented the Treasure and Space Coast insisted on an investigation into the results of the election. They represent mostly conservative counties and the red-swinging St. Lucie County. Few members of Congress have been more aggressive than Posey in calling for investigations into the results of the election. I will not turn a blind eye to this election fraud on January 6. Posey tweeted this on New Year's Eve. The Florida Department of Health in Martin County on Monday began administering the COVID-19 vaccine to people 65 and older. A long line of cars could be seen early Monday morning outside the health department's main office in Stewart as seniors waited to receive the vaccine produced by Moderna. Martin County health officials began making appointments last Tuesday for people 65 and older and quickly experienced an overwhelming volume of calls. Officials said all appointments are currently booked this week and more appointments will reopen once there is more supply of the Moderna COVID-19 vaccine. Officials said 800 people are expected to be vaccinated at the health department this week. The health department received about 34,000 calls in just 4 days last week for an appointment. All Florida seniors are encouraged to get the coronavirus vaccine, but Governor Ron DeSantis says they'll need to be patient.
I can't guarantee you, obviously, every senior is going to be able to get vaccinated tomorrow or the next day, but I can guarantee you, as long as we keep getting in, that's going to be the priority, and we want to get it done as soon as possible.
DeSantis says they're pushing doses of the vaccine out to hospitals and local health departments as soon as they arrive. He says some COVID testing sites and houses of worship will be converted into inoculation locations to speed up the rollout of the vaccine. Many Florida seniors who have been vaccinated against COVID are thinking of others as they roll up their sleeve, says Seminole County Health Director Donna Walsh.
It's interesting, as people have come through to get their vaccine, 65 years of age and older, many have asked, how can I volunteer? How can I help you? These are retired nurses. These are people who aren't even in the medical field. So thank you for that.
Walsh says they've taken down names and those people will be deployed in teams out in the community to get the vaccine safely into as many arms as possible as soon as possible. Hospitals are now have to disclose the rates they privately negotiate with insurers under a Trump administration rule that took effect Friday. While President Donald Trump has boasted that the historic measure will save patients money, health policy experts aren't so sure, and hospitals which unsuccessfully fought the rule in court says it's an extra burden on them while they're battling the coronavirus. The effort stems from an executive order Trump issued in 2019. The administration argues that such price transparency will allow patients to shop for lower-priced medical services and help reduce healthcare costs overall, one of the president's main promises during his campaigns and while in office. Florida drivers are beginning the new year with much lower prices at the pump than they saw to begin in the 2020, 33 cents a gallon lower than this time a year ago. To 219. AAA says gas prices averaged 211 for all of 2020, and that's the lowest yearly average in 16 years. And lastly, McDonald's is launching new sandwiches next month in an effort to win fast food's chicken war. On Monday, the company announced three versions of a new chicken sandwich, which will be available nationally on February 24th. The crispy chicken sandwich, topped with pickles and served on a potato roll. The spicy chicken sandwich, which adds a spicy pepper sauce. And the deluxe chicken sandwich, which comes with lettuce, tomatoes, and mayo. How about a chicken sandwich for breakfast? The Jacksonville Jaguars finished the season with the worst record in franchise history and at 1-15, and that has resulted in the firing of head coach Doug Marrone. Our news time is 6:25, and we'll have weather and traffic together next.
Incurred roof damage in the last 2 years, Code Red Roofers is there to help you with all of your roofing needs. Code Red Roofers, the roofers who respond 24/7, and there are flexible payment options for metal, tile, shingle, or flat roofs. Code Red Roofers, say habla español. Code Red Roofers, 844-4-CODE-RED. That's 844-4-CODE-RED.
It's time to get up and go show. It's time for traffic and weather together, all brought to you by Code Red Roofers. Bonnie?
Wow, it's a nice-looking Tuesday morning here on the Treasure Coast, traffic-wise. We don't have any accidents to report, including our beautiful Fort Pierce area, Palm City, Stewart here, too. We are looking fine traffic-wise. Your latest look at traffic. And it's a chilly kind of morning, too. It's 48 in Port St. Lucie. In Joplin, Missouri this morning, only 28 degrees. Here's our weather at WPTV.
It's a cold start to the morning along the Treasure Coast. Temperatures starting off in the 40s under mostly clear skies. This afternoon, highs in the low 70s, mostly sunny skies and light northwesterly winds. Tomorrow morning, another cold start to the day. Temperatures dropping to the 40s tonight. Highs in the low 70s once again with abundant sunshine. Thursday, temperatures return to average, morning lows in the mid-50s and highs in the mid-70s. Friday, isolated rainfall possible as another cold front makes its way down the state.
I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Katya Hall on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
And get coffee, go to work, swing by the grocery store, eat dinner, go to sleep, get up, do it all over again. Seacoast believes spending time with your loved ones should be on your everyday to-do list. Seacoast Air Conditioning, family-owned and operated for over 38 years, knows the importance of family. Whether it's reading a bedtime story, sharing your day around the dinner table, or just picking up the phone and calling mom, these are the moments that are remembered for a lifetime.
Comfort crisis? Don't roast. Call Seacoast.
Hello, this is Gary Owen of the Owen Insurance Group. We are a local independent insurance agency located right here on the Treasure Coast. I've been a resident here for 34 years and have helped thousands of clients with their insurance planning needs. We specialize in life, health, and Medicare insurance planning. Don't travel the road alone. Let us be your guide. We are the Owen Insurance Group. Contact us today at 772-210-1020 or visit our website at oweninsurancegroup.net.
So, have you heard this one? A priest and a rabbi come into this radio station. Really, it's a priest and a rabbi. Right here, Friday mornings beginning at 9. Here on WSTU, AM 1450. Bring your questions and join their lively conversation with Father Christian from St. Mary's Episcopal Church and Rabbi Matt Durbin from the Temple Beit Hayim. It's a priest and a rabbi. Friday mornings at 9 here on WSTU.
No hype, just facts. I'm Casey, and I invite you to tune into the Casey Ingram Show every Tuesday from 5 to 6 p.m. Hear from community leaders, learn about some of our great local nonprofit organizations, get the latest updates from our elected officials, and meet the candidates. Even rock and roll legends have joined the show from time to time. I'm conservative, but not divisive, bringing you the talk of the community. It's a fun and interesting hour beginning at 5 p.m. every Tuesday on WSTU AM 1450 and Facebook Live at The Casey Ingram Show.
Let's get back to the Get Up and Go Show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
Get ready for the latest film from Francis Ford Coppola, The Dawn Father.
We won the election, and it's not fair to take it away from us like this.
You can act like a man! What's the matter with you?
They are shredding ballots, in my opinion.
That's how you turn out? What can I do? What can I do?
The Dawn Father, now playing in Georgia theaters.
Yeah, The Dawn Father.
Yeah.
How about that one? The Dawn Father.
The Dawn
Father. Yeah. The Dawn Father.
Now you can kiss my
right
Dawn
cheek. Father, right, you know what, out the window. There you go. Let's do some viral videos. Well, I said videos, but video. I only have one viral video this morning. I'll set this one up. It's a clip that's been around for a while, but it's very heartwarming and relevant. Right now, a little girl is very nervous about getting vaccinated. So her dad holds her in his lap, and he pretends to get the shot first. And then they inoculate the little girl second. So listen in.
You gotta turn that way around so I can't look.
Ooh.
Once again.
Oh. Went in for dad. Ready?
You're gonna put my thing
your turn.
On.
Ready? Ooh, that
job.
Oh, man, that look. Thing hurt a little bit, huh?
Yeah. Ooh, just a little bit.
Man.
She look good,
because
they don't act like this.
Huh? Big Cody knock him down. Ooh, man, this one, it sting a little bit.
A little bit, huh?
He just playing her.
Yep.
He is just playing that little girl like you have no idea.
The last one.
Here goes shot number two.
Don't look, Cody.
That's nothing.
Right. There it went. He got it in his arm.
That's one.
Good girl.
Bow, bow, chicka, bow, bow.
Bound chicka bound bound is what he said.
And it's so much easier seeing Dad getting inoculated too.
Yeah,
seeing,
sure.
You know, Dad go through it, and you know, when I was a little kid, I kind of wished my mom and Dad would come with me in there and hold my hand, and you know, while I get that shot in the arm.
Can I tell you a little secret?
Yes.
I still have to have my hand held when I get a shot. I am a big baby.
Yeah.
I'm a huge baby.
You know what, Evan?
What?
You want to know another secret?
Sure.
I'm a big baby, too, about it.
Are you really?
Yeah.
You're a wuss like I am.
I really am. It makes me feel guilty because it's, like, really important to go and donate blood.
Yeah.
And, I mean, you have to take a shovel after me to do it.
I haven't donated blood in forever.
Yeah.
I mean, literally forever.
Well, at least you can say that you've done it before, right?
I have.
Yeah.
I have, but it was like for shizzle ages ago.
Uh-huh.
We're still looking to give away the Ellie's Downtown Deli gift certificate that we're looking for a good joke this morning. If you have a good joke and you want to tell us a good joke, you can give us a call. If you can make either Bonnie or myself laugh this morning, you have to make us laugh. We'll give you a gift certificate to Ellie's Downtown Deli, 220-9788. You can be listening to us on either of the two radio stations, 220-9788. Make us laugh, and we will reward you very graciously.
Yeah, it is gracious, too, because the food is very delicious at Ellie's Deli.
It is. It really, truly is. And the chocolate chip cookie is as big as your head.
Uh-huh.
I kid you not.
And fluffy Oreo pie.
Yes, definitely. Definitely so. Bonnie, did you know that 32% of parents say getting kids to get along is the most difficult aspect of parenting?
Yeah.
How does Topanga and the other one get along?
They get along fine, but, you know, just like typical kids, they're going to have their fights and arguments once in a while.
Yeah.
I'll always remember my Uncle Ron when he had this pickup truck with a little window in the back.
Mm-hmm.
Like he'd drive in the front, and then there was a window going back to the back cabbie. So my cousins would always ride back there when they traveled. And I always remember my uncle opening up that little slide window while he was driving and going, shut up, kids.
Really?
Stop fighting.
Oh,
settle
my.
Down. But,
okay.
You know, siblings, they're always going to rival once in a while.
Want to say good morning to Michelle Bonan. She's watching us on Facebook this morning, along with my good friend Melissa, who I used to work with at a bowling alley when I was a manager there quite a while ago.
Wow. Was that down in the Lauderdale area?
No, that was up in Port St. Lucie.
Oh, yeah? Up at the Lanes?
Yep.
Up here?
Yep.
Oh, that's a great place to go and bowl, like on a Saturday night.
It's closed due to COVID.
Yeah, I miss that Saturday night when they
I used to actually
turn
DJ.
On the lights and the big party.
I used to DJ at St. Lucie Lanes. Me and Mighty Mike used to do that.
Yeah.
We used to have a good time.
So much fun when they play the upbeat dance music, too, and you're bowling and...
Oh, yeah.
Having a beverage or two.
Yeah, adult beverage in your case.
Maybe a soda.
What is soda? Get something from the snack bar. Did you know that 72% of people in a new poll say they sleep better and are happier the more they clean the house?
Me too.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Do you sleep better
after
you clean the house?
Yeah, because I hate to go to bed at night when my house is feeling like a wreck or that I didn't get anything done.
Okay.
You know how you go to work and you want to do your job well and, you know, do well for your employer.
Okay.
It's kind of like when you have a house, when you own a house, Evan, that's your palace too. And that's a job in itself.
Right. It's my kingdom.
Your kingdom. And you want to and that's work involved too.
Mm-hmm.
So you care about what you do at your place of employment. You got to care about what you do at home, right?
So your place is called a palace because you're the queen of the home.
I don't know about that.
And then you know, I have a kingdom because I'm the king of my home.
Yes.
So see, you have a palace and I have a kingdom.
And Jack Frosty is our prince of pee.
Yeah, prince of pee. Damn cat. Is that cat still peeing on the carpet or what?
I'm trying my best to just, you know,
you can't
do
break,
everything.
You can't break the cat, can you?
I have three or four litter boxes going now. And
good
I'm,
God.
I'm monitoring.
Three or four.
I'm monitoring. Jeez. I'm following around. I'm locking him out of. He's been. There are closed doors now. You know, we're doors
the
for.
In, the cat's in kitty jail?
Doors for him were open once upon a time. Those doors are now closed.
Wow.
Cat people probably know what I mean.
Do you have tile floors or carpet?
We have like marble floors and
So you have no carpet in your house.
No carpeting.
Okay, that's kind of that works to your advantage if the cat pees on the floor.
Yeah,
because it's easy to clean up. Now, if you had carpet, you'd be in a whole nother league.
Even with wood flooring, you don't.
But still, it's easier to clean up than it is carpet.
It is.
It's 10 times easier.
Do you guys have a Swiffer?
I swear by the
Swiffer.
No, I don't. We have like three different types of vacuums.
Yeah.
And we have ceramic tile in one bedroom and in the kitchen, and that's it. And then most of the house has been recarpeted except for my wife's office and my radio studio at home.
Is it hard keeping the carpeting clean throughout the house?
Not really. I mean, we vacuum about once a week,
and
it fills up pretty good because Kaya sheds, so we get a good amount of hair.
Oh, yeah.
I took Kaya out front and brushed her off the other day. I was like, oh, my gosh.
I mean, that's a job in its own, having a pet, right?
I mean,
you're going to put in
at least... you got two of them, for God's sakes.
Oh, you put in like...
Could just settle for one. You had to get two.
You put in 10 hours a week,
yeah.
You know, just cleaning up after them.
Easily, and then cleaning the pee up, too.
But I would still suggest to get a pet. You know, they're good for...
They're great.
They're good for your psyche.
They're good.
Yeah.
Bonnie, did you know that a recent study shows that 54% of women... think they look their best in the summer months.
Mm.
In the summer. What are your thoughts on that?
It depends where you live.
Okay.
Because, see, down here in Florida, I think I look my best during the winter months because of the humidity and, you know, hot, humid summer. You walk outside, you just have done your hair, and then your hair falls apart.
Okay.
All
Here's
humidity.
Another interesting fact, and I'm not picking on you this morning. These are just women facts that came across my morning show prep this morning. Did you know that 66% of women say that eating chocolate relaxes them?
Mm-hmm.
Now, how are you in that aspect? When you eat chocolate, does it zen you? Does it zen you out? Does it relax you? Or does it make you happy?
It's like
an
instant high, and it makes me happy at first.
Okay.
But then maybe a half hour or so later, I'm saying, why did I go off that little diet and eat all that chocolate?
Okay.
So it's a... it's a non-win situation for me.
Did you know, here's a very interesting stat. Did you know, Bonnie, that on average, a person's voicemail greeting lasts just 22 seconds?
Mm-hmm.
22 seconds.
Yep, that's all it should last. Capture your attention.
Okay, that's all it does.
Here I am, leave your note, leave your message, and...
Now, I wonder how long my voicemail greeting is.
How long is it, Evan?
Well, we're going to find out.
Are you going to play it?
Yeah, we're going to find out. Here's what we're going to do. Let me do this here. I'm going to bring up a phone line. Okay, I'm going to call my phone.
I got to change mine. Mine is ancient. People
is
call
it?
Me up and I sound angry.
Really?
I do.
You sound angry?
Yeah. It says leave a message for...
Okay, so let me decline the call and hit start.
Hello and thank you for calling. I'm sorry, but I'm unavailable to take your call right now, but your call is very important to me. So at the tone, please leave me your name, your phone number, and a brief message, and I will call you back at my earliest convenience.
Okay.
Again, thank you for calling, and here comes the tone.
So there's my voicemail. That was 18 seconds.
That's a very nice greeting, too.
That was 18 seconds.
And I think that's just about right. You didn't even need that lengthier, you know, Evan?
Yeah, that was 18 seconds worth.
Right.
But see, it has to sound professional because of my business, my entertainment business.
Mm-hmm. It did sound professional, okay. And you want to keep it short, I think, because in this day and age, people won't have all day to, you know, sit and listen to your greeting.
Right. They don't want to hear your life story.
Simple and to the point.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Did you know that experts say that people reach the peak of their ability to see ghosts at the age of 8 years old?
Ooh.
At the age of
eight.
I wonder
who did that.
I don't know. I don't know. That's a very interesting stat. Sorry. Did you know that 13% of men have tried on their partner's bra, but may not tell anyone that they have done it before?
Yikes.
Okay, so.
Yikes.
All right, so here we go. Moment of truth. Okay, moment of truth. Bonnie, has Gary ever tried your bra on that you know of?
Not that I know of.
Okay. Okay. I'll admit I tried Rachel's once.
And does Rachel know about this?
Probably not.
You did it? You're one of those.
Yeah, I did it.
In that, what is it, a 13% bracket?
I'm in the 13%.
Evan, that's weird. I'm looking at you right now like in a whole new light, bro.
Hey, what can I say? My feminine side came out. That was ages ago, though. I was much younger.
I'll have to ask Gary if he ever did that when I get home.
Seriously, we should call him right now. That would be hilarious.
Do it.
Are you serious? You want me to call him? Is he awake this early?
Yeah, he will be.
I can't believe that. We're going to call Gary. We're going to ask Gary if he's ever done that before.
Oh, wait, now, you know what? I was going to look up his number. I think I might have just remembered it.
Okay, just write it down for me. I can't believe we're going to call Gary this early in the morning.
He's home.
Oh, Lord.
He's home. I have a funny feeling he might be up.
Okay.
I hope we don't wake him up.
Well, hopefully we won't. Okay, let's see. We get a dial tone here. Calling up Bonnie's boyfriend here. We're going to ask him the question if he's ever tried on your
good golly, Miss Molly.
Yeah. What are you gonna do if he says yes?
I don't know. I'll be surprised if he answers.
Well, we'll see. This is your idea to call him now. You said sure, call him. You said yes.
Okay.
And he's probably if we wake him, he's gonna be so mad this morning.
I know.
Oh my Lord.
Hello.
Well, good morning. How you doing, buddy?
Hey, hold on a second.
Oh, sure. I says, hold on.
I'm sorry. Hey,
this is live radio. You can't tell live radio to hold on. It's me and your girlfriend.
Good morning.
I had to pause Cobra Kai.
Oh, okay. Hey, so listen, we're talking about stats this morning, Gary. And one very interesting stat came up, and I thought, I answered the question.
He did quite honestly.
I answered it quite honestly, and I said, well, let's call Gary and ask Gary. So I'm like, all right, well, let's ask Gary. Now, this could pertain to Bonnie or anybody else, okay?
Okay.
The stat is, did you know that 13% of men have tried on their partner's bra but never told anybody about it?
She knows I have. I answered the door for the pizza guy in her underwear.
At the time.
That's no secret.
At the time, I thought you were just wearing a dress.
Oh,
that dress
God.
Looked kind of droopy.
See?
So I didn't.
I think I was wearing a dress and high heels or something.
See, I told her. I told Bonnie I did it, and she said, she says to me, she goes, "Wow, I look at you in a whole new light now."
When I was getting married, my ex-wife.
Yeah.
Before we got married, she had a negligee for the wedding. And I put it on, and I'm sitting back watching TV wearing this thing. She didn't even notice. And then she's like, what the hell are you doing?
You know what?
Well, there you have it. See, Gary and I have a feminine side that comes out.
And I remember him answering the door to the delivery driver wearing a dress, and Gary's already tall at 6'1", wearing high heels.
Oh, jeez.
So he reminded me of Tom Hanks back in Bosom Buddies when Hanks would dress in the dress.
Wow.
And the pizza driver, delivery driver, was just like, what?
Wow. Gary, you have to come and sit in with us one morning. I'm telling you, there's always an open door, and I've told Bonnie that already. You have to come and sit in one morning.
I will. I appreciate it.
I want you to come in, and I'll bring, if you come in, I'll bring breakfast. How's that? I'll even do one better yet. I'll one better up. I'll bring in, not my Ninja Foodie Grill that you have now, that you enjoyed your brand new steaks on last night.
It was good.
Right? Exactly. I'll bring in my induction cooker, and I'll cook us some breakfast in here in the morning.
Sounds good, man.
All right, so just let me know what morning you want to come in.
Hey, thanks a lot, Evan.
All right, buddy, take care.
Bye.
Bye. Well, there you go, Bonnie.
You know, I heard you on a program this last week. You were talking about your induction cooker,
Evan.
Oh,
yeah, yes.
You were telling, I think it was Gary Owens,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, Gary Owens show. Yeah, Gary Owens, Owen Insurance.
I remember.
Quality of life.
I was listening to you all that one
morning. Takes it takes a special type of pan that will only work on an induction cooker. Now, the induction cooker is very cool because you can put your hand on it, and it's not hot at all.
You're kidding.
Transmits no heat at all. It's all done through induction.
That would be safe for little hands around the kitchen.
Yeah,
you got
definitely.
Little kids following you around.
Yep. We have a call coming in, so let's go to our phone lines. Good morning. You're on the air with Evan and Bonnie. Who's this?
Ba-ba-ba-boo.
Oh, wow. Look who's up this early in the morning. It's Fredo, our band leader. Hey, Fredo. How are you this morning?
Good morning. Hi, Bonnie.
Hi, Fredo.
How are you, buddy?
Hi.
Doing good. I was just calling to tell you about my new self-help program. It's for men who wear their ladies' bras. Yeah, man. You come and you sit on my couch, and I hit you over the head with a baseball bat and tell you what you're thinking about. Yeah, man.
It's funny how you just came up with that, Fredo.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Well, you know, Fredo's an entrepreneur. So he comes up with all these different ideas. That's why he's our fearless band leader, Fredo and the Shy Guys. They're in the other room, in the green room, and they've been performing all week. They've learned a whole bunch of new tunes.
They've been sounding good.
Yeah, they're really sounding good.
Man.
They got a whole lot of new songs, Fredo.
Yes, we've learned a bunch of new songs, and we just keep practicing, get some new songs out, you know.
I like that.
They had a little break.
It kind of reminds me of the day with Count Basie, you know, when we were with them and did all sorts of cool stuff. Yeah.
Hey, so, Fredo, we're doing a contest this morning, all morning long. We're giving away an Ellie's Deli gift certificate to the person that can come up with a joke that can actually make myself or Bonnie belly laugh. So, do you happen to have a good one-line joke that you could tell that is radio material?
Well, I heard, who's that guy, John, that's been calling up with those jokes lately?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Yeah, man, I'm going to go on tour with him.
Really?
Yeah, he's going to open up for Bonnie. And along with Big Kid, he's going to open up for Bonnie when she does her big concert. Yeah,
okay.
Man, I think those two will be great.
So you and John together can do a comedy show like Jeff Dunham and Peanut?
Something like that, yeah,
but
man.
But the thing is, though, who would be the dummy?
Wasn't there another guy? Oh, you were going to have John join Marty, too, our friend Marty.
Well, yeah, Marty Jacobson.
Yeah,
so we have a trio there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, man.
Okay.
All right, don't you got to go to the news?
Yeah, okay. Well, yeah, I got to go to the news.
Someone sounded irritated.
Yeah, you're the one that interrupted my show this morning, but that's all right. We always
welcome. Well, you're the one sitting there talking about wearing ladies' bras and stuff like that, you weirdo. What are you doing there, man?
All right, Fredo. Tone it down a notch, okay?
Hold on. I can put my panties on. I'll see you later.
All right. Bye-bye. Excuse me while I go change in the other room. Bonnie, would you do the news, please? Thank you.
Thank you, Evan. The Republican National Committee begins its in-person winter meeting at Amelia Island today. There's a lot on the agenda, with some Republicans planning to object as Congress moves to ratify results of the presidential election tomorrow.
Republicans are in a holding pattern right now to see what Donald Trump's going to do, how he exits office and how he talks to his supporters and what Donald Trump plans for the future.
The coronavirus death toll in Florida now tops 22,000. The Department of Health announcing 103 additional fatalities yesterday, along with more than 11,000 new cases. Florida continues to ramp up its COVID vaccine program with a focus on getting senior citizens protected from the virus.
Our senior population deserves to be the priority. We were the first to come out of the gate on that. We've had Texas and I think Louisiana, Georgia, Colorado has followed suit.
The Florida Department of Health in Martin County on Monday began administering the COVID-19 vaccine to people 65 and older. A long line of cars could be seen early Monday morning outside the health department's main office in Stewart as seniors waited to receive the vaccine produced by Moderna. Martin County health officials began making appointments last Tuesday for people 65 and older and quickly experienced an overwhelming volume of calls. Officials said all appointments are currently booked this week, and more appointments will reopen once there is more supply of the Moderna COVID-19 vaccine. Officials said 800 people are expected to be vaccinated at the health department this week. The health department received about 34,000 calls in just 4 days last week for an appointment. Two missing children are now safe after police in Port St. Lucie used a drone to locate them on Sunday. Sergeant Kenneth Boehm said officers responded to the 2200 block of Southwest Almanar Street after receiving a report about the missing children. Police learned two families were having a play date when the children slipped out the front door. The children apparently went looking for their older siblings who had just left for a ride on a recreational vehicle, according to Boehm. Officers searched the area but could not locate the small children. Boehm said a police drone pilot and visual observer later responded to the scene and quickly located the two children walking along a lake near their home. The drone pilot hovered above the children, keeping watch over them until the family picked them up. Hospitals now have to disclose the rates they privately negotiate with insurers under a Trump administration rule that took effect on Friday. While President Donald Trump has boasted that the historic measure will save patients money, health policy experts aren't so sure. And hospitals, which unsuccessfully fought the rule in court, says it's an extra burden on them while they're battling the coronavirus. The effort stems from an executive order Trump issued in 2019. The administration argued that such price transparency will allow patients to shop for lower-priced medical services and help reduce health care costs overall, one of the president's main promises during the campaigns and while in office. Lastly, pickle-flavored Doritos just went on sale nationwide. These things apparently popped up in a few spots last summer and looks like they were popular enough that Doritos decided to give them a wider launch. According to one review, they have a, quote, very pleasant dill and vinegar flavor. In his three-time NBA title winning career, Steph Curry has put in some dominant performances. However, he might have eclipsed that all on Sunday night in the Golden State Warriors' 137-122 win over the Portland Trail Blazers. Curry scored a career-high 62 points in his 36 minutes on the floor, finishing 18 for 31 from the field, 8 for 16 from three-point range, 18 of 19 from the free throw line, and had 5 rebounds and 4 assists afterwards. Curry called it a pretty crazy night. Yeah, Curry's previous career high was 54 against the New York Knicks in February of 2013. Amazing. News time is 6:54. We'll have weather and traffic together next.
Stepped into St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins, I figured it would just be one of my many stops on my road to the perfect engagement ring. My fiance means the world to me, so I wanted something extra special. I found a huge selection of engagement rings at great prices, and my worry about finding the perfect engagement ring was quickly replaced with exceptional customer service. St. Lucie Jewelry's over 400 five-star reviews really told the story. I finally picked a ring, and it was perfect. She was floored. And then the tears came.
Hi, This is Hawk Levy, owner of St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins. We're now celebrating 26 years, voted best diamond dealers, best jewelry buyers, and best jeweler year after year. Come celebrate with us in opening our third location at 1335 St. Lucie West Boulevard next to Publix. We invite you to take a tour of our competition, but then come see us last.
.656 the time on the Get Up and Go show with Evan and Bonnie. It's a blended show. G and Ray on vacation until next week. Time for traffic and weather together, all brought to you by Code Red Roofers. Bonnie?
Well, there is one accident, and this is up in the Vero Beach area. It's on I-95 southbound at mile marker 147 Vero Beach, and you should get through there. We're not finding any roadblock at the moment from that accident. Here in Martin County, it's a nice ride. So far, so good. There's your latest look at traffic. And in Palm City, we're at 49 in Moscow, Russia this morning, only 31. Here's our weather at WPTV.
It's a cold start to the morning along the Treasure Coast. Temperatures starting off in the 40s under mostly clear skies. This afternoon, highs in the low 70s, mostly sunny skies and light northwesterly winds. Tomorrow morning, another cold start to the day. Temperatures dropping to the 40s tonight. Highs in the low 70s once again with abundant sunshine. Thursday, temperatures return to average, morning lows in the mid-50s and highs in the mid-70s. Friday, isolated rainfall possible as another cold front makes its way down the state.
The professionals at Mark Brechtel Certified Public Accountants are proud to sponsor Treasure Coast Solutions, a community service program designed to provide information you can use, a local perspective on national issues, local solutions to meet your individual concerns. At our firm, we believe that information is knowledge, and with knowledge comes the power to have a positive impact on our lives, businesses, schools, and community. If you would like one of our professionals to address your personal financial or business concerns, please give us a call to set up an appointment at 220-3380.
Unfortunately, in today's litigious society, too many Americans fail to have an effective estate plan and asset protection strategy. I'm attorney TJ Heineman, and I've been counseling families, businesses, and executives for 20 years. I can help you preserve your wealth, safeguard your assets, and protect your family. My law firm specializes in estate planning and administration, asset protection, corporate law, and real estate. For a free copy of my Family Estate Planning Survival Guide or a free consultation in my Palm City office, call me, TJ Heineman, at 888-5667.
Are you looking for your dream home on the Treasure Coast? I am Eileen Simons, a licensed realtor with eXp Realty. My team and I can help you find your dream home. I bring 20 plus years experience in the residential real estate market, helping both buyers and sellers achieve their dreams. Call me at 772-200-5105 or visit our website at mydreamhomeusa.com.
Mornings are better with the Get Up and Go show with Evan and Bonnie on WSTU.
Coming up in the 8 o'clock hour, Major John Budensiek is going to be here in place of the sheriff. The sheriff is getting sworn back in today, Bonnie.
Yes.
For another term.
That's awesome.
Sheriff William Snyder, one of our favorite people to have on the program. We're WSTU Stewart, Martin County's Heritage Station, and we're WPSL, Port St. Lucie, the talk of the Treasure Coast. 7 o'clock, the news is coming up next in hour number two of a blended show right here. Don't go anywhere.
Show right here. Don't go anywhere.
Are just opening now across Georgia. I'm Dave Anthony, Fox News.
The power is literally in your hands.
President-elect Biden rallying Democrats in Atlanta for an election that matters to the whole country.
One state can chart the course, not just for the next 4 years, but for the next generation.
He's hoping John Ossoff and Raphael Warnock unseat two Republican senators to give Democrats control of the Senate. President Trump rallied Republicans last night in Dalton, Georgia.
And it could be your last chance to save the America that we love.
He's backing Senators David Perdue and Kelly Loeffler. The president also focused a lot last night on his ongoing election fights.
When you win in a landslide and they steal it and it's rigged, it's not a unacceptable.
A lot of Republicans plan to support his fight in Congress tomorrow. Fox's Rachel Sutherland has more live.
Dave, at least a dozen Republican senators and a growing number of GOP congressmen plan to object to the certification of President-elect Joe Biden's win during a joint session of Congress tomorrow. Senator Kelly Loeffler jumped on the bandwagon last night.
On January 6th, I will object to the Electoral College vote.
Meanwhile, voices in business, including the U.S. Chamber of Commerce, are calling on Congress to accept Biden's win. Dave?
Rachel, another federal judge has rejected another election lawsuit, claiming it was based on an obvious misreading of the Constitution.
The lawsuit filed by two Republican Wisconsin lawmakers and other groups sought to nullify election results in Wisconsin, Arizona, Georgia, Michigan, and Pennsylvania. The lawsuit alleged a cabal of public-private partnerships illegally conspired to prevent the president from winning those battleground states.
That's Fox's Steve Rappaport. And the number of Americans hospitalized in this coronavirus crisis, a new record, 128,000. America's listening to Fox News.
Newsmax TV is the biggest thing on cable news, with shows including Dick Morris, Rudy Giuliani, Michelle Malkin, Diamond and Silk, Mike Huckabee, Alan Dershowitz, and more. Every night, watch Newsmax's number one show, Greg Kelly Reports. Greg Kelly tells you the truth about Trump. Newsmax is on all major cable systems. Check your guide or tell your operator you want Newsmax. 30 million Americans watch Newsmax TV. And download the Newsmax app on your smartphone. It's free, so get Newsmax TV anytime, anywhere.
You know where you were when the Golden State Killer was arrested. You're a moderator on the Zodiac Killer subreddit. But now you're in search of a new challenge. Enter Solved, the hit podcast that puts you at the center of the investigation. Solved is like no other murder mystery podcast. You'll track down killers hiding in plain sight.
You all right?
Yeah, it's just disturbing. Have you ever seen anything like this before?
Not like this.
Listen to Solve wherever you get your podcasts.
Well, the new Congress was just sworn in Sunday, and there is already new controversy in the House, where Democrats have a slimmer majority.
A new rules package for the 117th Congress renews remote proxy voting, a pandemic precaution set up last year, and changes a legislative tool used by the minority party to change bills before final passage, known as motions to recommit.
So that it can no longer be used to hijack the legislative process.
Rules Committee Chairman Democrat Jim McGovern says the change will not limit Republicans' rights. GOP leader Kevin McCarthy disagrees.
Given me the passion to win back the majority so I can win back the voices on this floor, that they won't be denied.
The new rules package also eliminates some budget restrictions on pandemic and climate legislation and incorporates gender-neutral language. Jared Halpern, Fox News.
Today, after Iran seized a South Korean oil tanker, the ship's owner claims it was a military raid, saying Iranian troops forced them to change course and go to Iran. End of negotiations between the two countries. Billions of dollars in Iran assets are frozen in South Korean banks as part of the American pressure being put on Iran. The U.S. has also been putting pressure on China. However,
the New York Stock Exchange says it no longer plans to delist three Chinese telecommunications giants after consulting with the Office of Foreign Assets Control. The index said it had originally planned to drop the Chinese telecom listings in order to comply with President Trump's November executive order, which bars American companies from investing in firms he claims aid the Chinese military. China's Security Regulatory Commission on Monday said the order was based, quote, on political purposes. Other major indices, including the S&P and Dow Jones, have taken steps to comply with the order, which will go into effect next Monday. Sean Langell, Fox News.
On Wall Street, stock futures are barely higher the day after a sell-off to start 2021. I'm Dave Anthony, and this is Fox News.
Florida real estate is hot. Now is a great time to find your dream home. I am Eileen Simons, realtor with eXp Realty. Join me for My Dream Home every Monday morning at 10 a.m. on WPSL and WSTU. We'll talk about real estate, interview guest experts, have featured listings, and a featured community each week. That's My Dream Home radio show, Mondays at 10 on both WPSL and WSTU, and Alexa and Google Home on TuneIn.
Hi, I'm Chris Hodgins with My Florida Insurance Broker, and I'm here today with my daughter, Sage.
Hello.
Sage, why don't you tell everybody what kind of insurance we do?
Home insurance, car insurance, life insurance, and flood insurance.
If you've had a rate hike or two or five, hopefully not 10,
Give us a call. We'd love to hear from you. Sage, what's our number?
772-617-6777.
What's the name of our company again?
My Florida Insurance Broker.
No hype, just facts. I'm KC, and I invite you to tune into the Casey Ingram Show every Tuesday from 5 to 6 p.m. Hear from community leaders, learn about some of our great local nonprofit organizations, get the latest updates from our elected officials, and meet the candidates. Even rock and roll legends have joined the show from time to time. I'm conservative, but not divisive, bringing you the talk of the community. It's a fun and interesting hour beginning at 5 p.m. every Tuesday on WSTU AM 1450 and Facebook Live at The Casey Ingram Show.
Coming to you live from Seward, Florida, the greatest little town in the world, it's the Get Up and Go Show on AM 1450 WSTU. You're invited to call the show anytime at 772-220-9788. And now, broadcasting live from their palatial studios, here are your hosts, Evan and Bonnie.
Oh, thank you very much, Madam Announcer. 7:07 on a blended show. It's the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie, G and Ray on vacation.
Put that cookie down now!
Okay, I'll put the cookie down, okay? I'll put the cookie down.
I'll be back.
Okay, just take your time. You don't have to rush to get back here, okay? Please, don't rush to get back here.
Get that cat out of here!
All right, well, the cat has left the building. I'll say that much. The cat has finally left the building. That's a Get Up and Go Show band, Fredo and the Shy Guys. We are the only morning show that has a live band in our studio, in our green room, Bonnie.
And they're sounding better than ever, aren't they?
Right? You like the new songs they've learned?
Yeah. And they took some time off. You can tell they sound very refreshed.
Yep. Definitely so. And we're still looking for somebody that can make us belly laugh this morning. Okay, if you have a funny joke, we have a gift certificate to Ellie's Downtown Deli that we want to give you. Okay, 220-9788-220-WSTU. Give us a call, and if you can make us belly laugh this morning, we'll give you a $20 gift certificate to Ellie's Downtown Deli.
Yeah, and people drive to Seward. They come in droves from, like, Palm City, from Fort St. Lucie.
I've known people that come up from Palm Beach.
Just to get some of those good, fresh jumbo wraps.
Yeah, exactly. The food's that damn good. So all you got to do is make Bonnie or myself belly laugh. You have two of us that you can make laugh, and only one has to laugh.
And one of us laughs pretty easily.
Yeah, we do. I mean, you could, you know.
Not too hard.
I mean, it's not that hard to make us laugh. Not at all. We laugh pretty easily. I mean, all you got to do is make us do this. That's it. That's all you got to do.
And we are in the Stewart studio where we're at 220 WSTU.
Yes.
220-9788.
Make our phone ring, and we will definitely give you, and we will reward you with a Ellie's Downtown Deli gift certificate. Let's do birthdays and anniversaries back in the day. News on the radio. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. All right, Bonnie, so what do you have for me this morning?
Any birthdays or anniversaries? No, yeah. I don't.
You have nothing?
Maybe some of our listeners do.
All right.
I don't have very many people happy belated birthday to Lisa, I guess, who
right.
I graduated with from high school. And,
all right.
You know, it's this thing upsets me sometimes about Facebook. It's like you're not on Facebook every single day, but sometimes you miss to wish happy birthday to some of your great friends. And you're wondering if they're wondering, well, why didn't she wish me a happy birthday?
This is true.
Does that bother you ever? I mean, it should not bother someone, you know, a little tiddly matter like that. But
see, we're not mind readers.
Sometimes it does.
All you have to do is tell us it's your birthday and we'll shout it out. So if you have a birthday, you can email the morning show, wstumorningshow@gmail.com. You can find us on all social media outlets at WSTU Morning Show. Pretty simple. Hi, you're on the air with Evan and Bonnie. Good morning. And
I'm going to keep calling and keep telling you jokes until you laugh.
Okay, all right. So this is John.
No, we don't laugh at any of your jokes, John.
No, John. So this is John, and John is going to make an attempt. We're going to give you three tries. We'll give everybody three tries, okay? So you have three tries to make us belly laugh, okay, John?
All right,
go ahead. The floor is all yours.
I'm not going to tell you all three at once. I'm going to call you back three times.
Oh.
Two more times.
Oh, okay. All right. So you have between now and 9 a.m. to call us.
Well, some years back, I had a girlfriend that wanted to make love on a horse.
Okay.
And I really didn't want to. And I, you know, said, no. Well, anyway, she talked me into it. We get on the horse. We started talking, kissing, hugging, you know, sweet talking. And things were getting hot and heavy. And all of a sudden, this guy comes running out of Kmart and unplugs it.
Okay.
Come on.
Well, that didn't go over too well, John.
Well, it's a funny joke. I mean, I tell it to the audience Bonnie's... of the pineapple, and they have to change their diaper.
Okay. You know? Well, Bonnie's laughing a little bit, but she's not belly laughing.
Yeah, and you didn't really get a chuckle out
again.
Of Evan.
All right.
So try back later.
Try back a little later.
All right. Bye-bye.
All right, John. Thank you. All right. Well, there's John, one of our friends from the morning show.
He's one silly guy.
Yeah, he is.
He is.
Unplug the horse.
Uh-huh.
Wow. Okay. Anyway.
John unplugged.
John unplugged. Hopefully Fredo's listening and Fredo can guide him a little bit. Probably Fredo will open up another new business called Fredo's Joke Telling Service.
There you go. And he probably will, knowing Fredo.
Christine Cavallari is 34 years old today, Bonnie. That's the Laguna Beach and the Hill star. She recently separated from her former NFL quarterback husband, Jay Cutler.
Wow, she did?
Yeah.
I never heard that they separated there.
Yeah, they separated.
I thought they were just a year ago, it seems, in the tabloids anyway. They were all hot and heavy and good.
Yeah. Huh. January Jones is 43 years old today. That's Melissa on Last Man on Earth. Now, who in God's name names their child after a month of the year? I can understand the name June. Okay.
Yeah.
I can understand June.
What about May?
May is a good one.
Uh-huh.
Okay, May is a good one. April is a good one.
I don't mind January.
How would you like to name your son March? Hey, March, come here.
I don't think I'd name my kid October either.
Yeah.
That's on the awkward side.
Yeah, that's on the very strange
January, the name January, I don't mind that.
Or how about after a day of the week, like on the Addams Family?
Mm-hmm.
They had somebody named Tuesday or something like that.
Yeah, they did.
Right.
Little Tuesday. Yeah, that's not so bad.
Yeah. Hey, Tuesday, come here. I need you to get to Wednesday for me. Our family has seven kids. They name each day of the week.
Yeah.
A child after each day of the week.
I would want to be named after the fun one on Saturday.
Imagine telling Monday to go get Tuesday, and then Tuesday says to Monday, well, I can't get Tuesday because it's not here yet.
Yeah. And then Tuesday wraps into Wednesday.
Right. And then Wednesday said, you know, you tell Wednesday to go get Monday, and you get the answer back. Well, that passed 2 days ago.
And Thursday flirts with Friday.
Exactly.
And they shouldn't.
And then Saturday and Sunday, and you're back doing it all over again.
I guess so.
Okay. Bradley Cooper, we just went on a tangent that meant no sense at all.
No, it didn't.
Bradley Cooper is 46. That's the Star is Born star.
Yeah, you know, I think he's pretty diverse.
Yeah.
You know, he's really making his own I love what he did, of course, in The Hangover. Mm-hmm. Very funny.
Yep.
A serious role in A Star is Born. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, he played the sniper too, an American sniper.
Sure did.
Where he had to gain a lot of weight for that film.
Sure did.
I think he's pretty good.
Marilyn Manson. 52 years old today. That is one weird person right there.
Marilyn Manson. Like the Alice Cooper of today.
Yeah, the Alice Cooper of today. He's missing a chicken nugget in his Happy Meal. That's all I got to say.
I'm not so sure.
Strange.
I don't know too much about him, I'll admit.
Yeah.
I mean, I see him. He looks. There was always an assumption that the little boy from the Wonder Years, mm-hmm. Kevin Arnold's best friend next door, the kind of. The nerdy-looking boy with the glasses and very short hair, there was a rumor that he was Marilyn Manson, and Marilyn is him grown up. I think that one is just a rumor, too.
Carrie Ann Inaba is 53. That's the Dancing with the Stars judge. She also was one of the dancers in the 1995 strip classic Showgirls.
I didn't know she was a dancer in Showgirls.
Yes.
Wow.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Vinnie Jones, 56 years old today. That's the Joggernaut in X-Man. Clancy Brown, 62. He's one of the guys that you absolutely love to hate. He played the brutal prison guard Captain Hadley in the Shawshank Redemption. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Very good. Pamela Sue Martin, 68 years old today. That's the star from the old school Nancy Drew mysteries.
How old is she?
68 years old today.
She was like the original old school Nancy Drew,
yeah.
Right?
Yep, sure was.
Uh-huh. I remember that would come out after school along with the Hardy Boys.
Yep, exactly.
Those were good.
Ted Lang, 73 years old today. He is Isaac the bartender on The Love Boat.
I love Isaac.
He had the thickest mustache. He had a Steve Harvey mustache.
He kind of reminds you of Steve Harvey,
right, a little
doesn't
bit,
he?
Except he's got more hair than Steve Harvey.
Yeah. And he was always smiling.
Yeah.
I would
exactly.
want him to be on my bartender if I went on a boat cruise.
Him and Steve Harvey could be made for different brothers from different mothers who have sisters from different misters.
Who knows? Maybe they are related somehow.
Anything is
right?
possible. Diane Keaton, 75 years old today.
75.
75 for Diane Keaton.
And she was in Godfather 2, right? Played Al Pacino's lady. She was so young in that movie.
Yep. Charlie Rose, 79 years old today. And Robert Duvall, 90 years
90,
old today.
Uh-huh.
A list of movies that I'll be here till 10 o'clock reading the list.
Right.
Just a few of them. The Godfather, MASH, The Natural, The Apostle, The Gingerbread Man, Assassination Tango, The Judge, Jack Reacher. The list goes on and on.
Yeah. Might want to tune in for one of those this week. Hey, you know what, too, Evan? I mentioned a bunch of new good stuff and movies and shows coming out on Netflix for January.
Okay.
We mentioned that yesterday, but
right.
I forgot to mention our favorite one, Cobra Kai Season 3 is out.
That's what Gary mentioned.
Yeah.
Earlier when we talked to him.
I'm way behind him because he's like watched the entire season almost already.
Wow.
And I haven't even finished like Season 2.
Wow.
So I got, you know, like I've had some catching up to do. But yeah, that's another one you can get for free this month on Netflix.
All right, very good.
We paid for episodes in the past, so I don't know if people care to get them for free.
Celebrating birthdays in the heavens, the original Superman of the 1950s series, George Reeves. He passed away in 1959. 1959, he passed away.
George Reeves. And wasn't the other Superman Christopher Reeves?
Yes.
Like they had the same last name?
Yep. I don't know if they were related or not.
Man.
But here's a very interesting fact, Bonnie.
Uh-huh.
The cast was only paid $200 per episode, and they had a BEG. They had to beg. That's right. Beg the producer to give them a $50 raise. They got it. But then the producer didn't speak to any of them for 2 weeks.
Really?
Yes.
I guess that's the way it goes.
And also, Reeves committed suicide in 1959, supposedly. Many people believe, though.
I think I have read that before.
Yeah, another conspiracy theory. Many people believe that he was murdered because of an affair with the wife of MGM executive E.J. Mannix.
There was something happening in a big house, like in a big, he was out in a Hollywood mansion.
Yeah.
And I think they theorized because when they found him deceased, there were almost like a party atmosphere, I'm pretty sure. A lot of people at the mansion.
Yep, for sure. Hi, you're on the air. Good morning. Who do we have the pleasure of speaking with?
This is Russ. I was going to call up and tell you guys a joke about guys wearing their girlfriend's bras, but you guys already told that one.
Oh, well, it wasn't a joke. It was just a fact. That's all it was. If you have a joke about that, you're more than welcome. If you have like a one or two liner joke, you're more than welcome to, Russ.
Can't even.
No, you told it pretty well.
Oh, okay. Well, Russ, let me ask you a question. Have you ever done that in your lifetime?
No, I've never dated a girl that had a chest small enough for me to put a bra on, even if I wanted to.
All right, well, that's a good one. That was a good one. I like that. All right, Russ. Well, thank you so much for listening this morning.
Does Russ get any Ellie's Deli from us?
You know, well, he's in the running.
In the running.
He got me to laugh pretty good on that little one-liner on the comeback there. So we'll announce the winner at the end of the program today, Russ.
All right.
Thanks for calling in. I appreciate it. And thank you so much, and Happy New Year to you.
You have a great day.
All right, very good. That was Russ calling in, one of our great listeners. 7:20 right now. It's news time. Let's go to the news desk where Bonnie is standing by with the headlines. Good morning, Bonnie.
Good morning, Evan. Two local members of Congress are challenging the election of President-elect Joe Biden, joining more than 100 Republicans who are casting doubt over the results. This despite state and federal courts, state election officials, and federal officials rejecting accusations of widespread fraud in the November 3 election. Representatives Bill Posey and Brian Mast, representing the Treasure and Space Coast, insisted on an investigation into the results of the election. They represent mostly conservative counties and the red-swinging St. Lucie County. Few members of Congress have been more aggressive than Posey in calling for investigations into the results of the election. Since November, the Rockledge Republican has primarily used his bully pulpit to pass on his doubts about the integrity of the election. Quote, "I will not turn a blind eye to this election fraud on January 6th. Posey tweeted this on New Year's Eve. Every Monday morning for the past 11 months, the Clean Water Coalition of Indian River County collects water samples from three locations near the Indian River Lagoon. What are they testing for? Harmful enteric bacteria, a sign of fecal pollution in water. In the past almost year of testing and analyzing the samples, the environmental group has found high levels of fecal matter in the lagoon. What we're trying to do is continue to bring awareness, said Paul Fafita, president of the coalition. The lagoon is in sad shape, and there are a number of things that need to be done to help it along the way. For the organization's 12 Days of Christmas wish, staff is asking for donations to continue the water sampling, which Felfita says is a costly operation. And right now, volunteers collect samples from these three locations, including Mac Williams Park, Dog Park, just north of the Merrill P. Barber Bridge, Vero Beach Wastewater Treatment Plant, and also on Oslo Road at the boat ramp. And here's how you can donate to the cause. You can mail donations to the Clean Water Coalition, P.O. Box 690761, Vero Beach, 32969, or donate online through CWCIRC.org. All Florida seniors are encouraged to get the coronavirus vaccine, but Governor Ron DeSantis says they'll need to be patient.
I can't guarantee you, obviously, every senior is going to be able to get vaccinated tomorrow or the next day, but I can guarantee you, as long as we keep getting in, that's going to be the priority, and we want to get it done as soon as possible.
Many Florida seniors, or DeSantis says they are pushing doses of the vaccine out to hospitals and local health departments as soon as they arrive. He says some COVID testing sites and houses of worship will be converted into inoculation locations to speed up the rollout of the vaccine. And many Florida seniors who have been vaccinated against COVID are thinking of others as they roll up their sleeves, says Seminole County Health Director Donna Walsh.
It's interesting, as people have come through to get their vaccine, 65 years of age and older, many have asked, how can I volunteer? How can I help you? These are retired nurses. These are people who aren't even in the medical field. So thank you for that.
Walsh says they've taken down names, and those people with will be deployed in teams out in the community to get the vaccine safely into as many arms as possible, as soon as possible. Two missing children are now safe after police in Port St. Lucie used a drone to locate them on Sunday. Sergeant Keith Boehm said officers responded to the 2200 block of Southwest Elminar Street after receiving a report about missing children. Police learned two families were having a play date when the children slipped out the front door. The children apparently went looking for their older siblings who had just left for a ride on a recreational vehicle, according to Boehm. Officers searched the area but could not locate the small children. Boehm said a police drone pilot and visual observer later responded to the scene and quickly located the two children walking along a lake near their home. The drone pilot hovered above the children, keeping watch over them until the family picked them up. an update to a story we had yesterday. Tanya Roberts, who captivated James Bond in A View to a Kill and later played Midge Pinciotti in the sitcom That 70s Show, was hospitalized after falling at her home. The actor had mistakenly been reported dead by her publicist earlier Monday. Roberts' publicist Mike Pingle later told the Associated Press on Monday that Roberts, 65, was still alive as of 10 a.m., but was in poor condition. He had said earlier Monday that Roberts collapsed in her home Sunday and was admitted to Cedars Sinai Medical Center. Multiple media outlets reported Roberts' death. And now let's take a quick look at sports. Since Luke Doncic was drafted by the Dallas Mavericks in 2018, he has quickly become one of the NBA's brightest stars. During his first two seasons in the league, the Slovenian has become accustomed to breaking records on an almost weekly basis. And on Monday night, he etched his name amongst the game's greatest players, once again becoming the fourth fastest player in NBA history to reach 1,000 points, 1,000 rebounds, and 1,000 assists. The 21-year-old put in his most dominant performance so far in the Mavs' 113-100 victory over James Harden and the Houston Rockets last night. Our news time, 7:26. We'll have weather and traffic together next.
This will be another El Nino year, although a weaker one. So if you incurred roof damage in the last 2 years, Code Red Roofers is there to help you with all of your roofing needs. Code Red Roofers, the roofers who respond 24-7. And there are flexible payment options for metal, tile, shingle, or flat roofs. Code Red Roofers, se habla español. Code Red Roofers, 844-4-CODE-RED. That's 844-4-CODE-RED.
Right now, the time to get up and go show with Evan and Bonnie. It's a blended show. G and Ray on vacation. Time for traffic and weather together. It's all brought to you by Code Red Roofers. Bonnie?
Well, Evan, up in the Vero Beach area, there is an accident, and this is on I-95 southbound Vero Beach. And it doesn't look like there's any roadblock from that accident at the moment. And back here in Martin County, of the other roads throughout St. Lucie County on a Tuesday morning, looking fine right now. There's your latest look at traffic. In Stewart, we have 51. In Moscow, Idaho, this morning, 36. Here's our forecast at WPTV.
It's a cold start to the morning along the Treasure Coast, temperatures starting off in the 40s under mostly clear skies. This afternoon, highs in the low 70s, mostly sunny skies and light northwesterly winds. Tomorrow morning, another cold start to the day, temperatures dropping to the 40s tonight, highs in the low 70s once again with abundant sunshine. Thursday, temperatures return to average, morning lows in the mid-50s and highs in the mid-70s. Friday, isolated rainfall possible as another cold front makes its way down the state.
I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Katya Hall on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
Go to work, swing by the grocery store, eat dinner, go to sleep, get up, do it all over again. Seacoast believes spending time with your loved ones should be on your everyday to-do list. Seacoast Air Conditioning, family-owned and operated for over 38 years, knows the importance of family. Whether it's reading a bedtime story, sharing your day around the dinner table, or just picking up the phone and calling mom, these are the moments that are remembered for a lifetime.
Comfort crisis? Don't roast. Call Seacoast.
The professionals at Mark Breckville Certified Public Accountants are proud to sponsor Treasure Coast Solutions, a community service program designed to provide information you can use, a local perspective on national issues, local solutions to meet your individual concerns. At our firm, we believe that information is knowledge, and with knowledge comes the power to have a positive impact on our lives, businesses,
schools, and community. If you would like one of our professionals to address your personal financial or business concerns, please give us a call to set up an appointment at 220-3380.
Hello, this is Gary Owen of the Owen Insurance Group. We are a local independent insurance agency located right here on the Treasure Coast. I've been a resident here for 34 years and have helped thousands of clients with their insurance planning needs. We specialize in life, health, and Medicare insurance planning. Don't travel the road alone. Let us be your guide. We are the Owen Insurance Group. Contact us today at 772-210-1020 or visit our website at oweninsurancegroup.net.
If someone in my family was diagnosed with skin cancer, I wouldn't care how nice the building looked or what was being said on the radio. I'd look for the best treatment options with the highest cure rates, and I'd find qualified physicians who could provide those treatments. I'm Dr. Tim Ioannidis. At Treasure Coast Dermatology, our board-certified doctors have the training and the experience to care for you and your loved ones. Don't come to Treasure Coast Dermatology based on our image alone.
Specializing in the treatment of skin cancer, board-certified dermatologists, Treasure Coast Dermatology.
Fuel your reopening with the power of talk radio. WPSL and WSTU Digital on TuneIn Worldwide and on Alexa at home, car, tablet, or phone.
Do you have a suggestion for the show? Send us an email. WSTUmorningshow@gmail.com. And now let's get back to the Get Up and Go show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
From the people who brought you The Good Doctor, bring you even more drama on The Bad Doctor.
Scalpel.
Uh-oh.
Not again.
The Bad Doctor, tonight on ABC.
Yeah, The Bad Doctor.
Stay away from The Bad Doctor.
Stay away from The Bad Doctor. I know one thing we don't want to stay away from, that stupid news this morning.
And now it's time for Stupid News.
It's so stupid and awesome.
Where we ask the important questions.
Are some people too stupid to live?
Why are people so stupid?
Are you effing stupid?
All right, so this kind of caught my eye this morning, and I can't make sense of this. Pizza Hut is celebrating their 25th anniversary. Okay, and to celebrate the 25th anniversary of Pizza Hut Stuffed Crust Pizza, the chain is giving away free pizzas this week, but here's the only catch.
Mm-hmm.
They're only giving away the stuffed crust.
Oh, so it's like a pizza ring.
So in other words, there's nothing in the middle.
Uh-huh.
There ain't a damn thing in the middle. They cut all the middle out, and it's a ring.
Okay.
It's just the crust.
You know, well, some people might enjoy the stuffed crust better than the actual pizza, which...
Now, I'm sorry, but I think that's the most idiotic, stupido, whatever you want to call it. I think it's stupid.
Well, you know, here's the note. I don't think it's that stupid.
Give
or
away
that,
the whole damn pizza.
I think they could use it better, like to sell it on the side as an appetizer that
way. I mean, are they trying to save money? I mean, what are they going to do? Add the stuffed crust to the menu? And let people order just a stuffed crust going forward?
They just want to try something exciting
and
new, I guess.
That just doesn't make flipping sense.
Do you like that part of the pizza, the stuffed crust?
When it's stuffed, yes, because I like the cheese.
And dipping it in the marinara sauce?
Yes, exactly.
Perfect, yeah.
Exactly.
But give me the whole darn pizza, right,
Yeah, give
Evan?
Me the whole damn pizza.
Yeah.
Yeah, please don't take the middle out. That just makes no sense at all. That is so idiotic.
I'm going to open up a donut shop and only sell donut holes.
Now, Dunkin' Donuts does that. That's called Dunkin' Munchkins.
Oh, do they? Yeah.
Yeah, that's where they get the little round center from.
I guess,
that's the center of the donut.
A center. And isn't that like with thinking of the fish place where they sell the hush puppies?
Yeah, that's like selling a cheeseburger and cutting a circle around it and not putting the meat in, and you just get the circumference of the bun. Just makes no sense.
No.
Hi, good morning. You're on the air with Evan and Bonnie. Who's this?
Yeah, this is Russ again. It's just mozzarella, toasted mozzarella bread. I mean, you probably would order it on the side.
Yeah, anyway. It's really that's exactly what it is. It's toasted mozzarella bread. It's like a mozzarella stick, but it's just they're toasting the dough, and what they do is they roll the dough and they put mozzarella cheese on the inside of the dough. That's all they're doing.
So what's wrong with doing that?
Yeah, but I mean, to sell it, like to give it away like that, I mean, why not include the whole pizza at least?
Because the pizzas are like $30 and the bread's probably 15 cents.
Yeah, but it doesn't cost them that much to make the pizza, though. Come on. The cost is not all that expensive. I mean, slap a little sauce, a little cheese. What do you think it literally costs to make a pizza pie? Probably $1.50?
No, way more than that.
$2? I mean, I could go buy...
If you go get the ingredients yourself and make it from flour, it's probably $10 for you to make a halfway decent pizza.
All right, so here's what I'm going to do, Russ. I'm going to go, when I get out of here today, I'm going to go to the store. I'm going to go buy the dough. There's dough that's pre-made in the refrigerated section of my local grocery store. So I'm going to get the dough. I'm going to buy a small jar of pizza sauce and a small bag of mozzarella cheese.
A small bag? That isn't going to get halfway across the pizza.
Well, my small bag maybe, I define it maybe a little different than other people do, but it'll be enough. I'll buy a bag that's enough to put on the pizza. And
well,
then,
that alone is going to be about $4.50.
Yeah, I'll agree. I will agree with you. Cheese is expensive. So, and I'll bring the receipt in and show Bonnie the receipt tomorrow.
And if it's less than $10, I'll let you keep that. Ellie's from Deli's. If I win it,
no, I wouldn't do that to you. I would still give it to you anyway. But no, I agree with you though. But I mean, seriously, they should, you know, as much money as Pizza Hut makes, they should just give out the whole damn pizza. As far as I'm concerned,
you know what pie I love to get is the Chicago style pizza with that deep dish.
Now I like a good barbecue style pizza.
Yeah, with a Chicago style, you pay, like Russ said, the most expensive ingredient is the cheese, and I will pay $20 for a good 12-inch Chicago style.
Yeah, exactly. Let's go to Moscow, Russia for our first stupid news story this morning, where a 24-year-old woman from Moscow, Russia, met her husband Gideon 5 years ago at a hardware store while shopping for photo shoot props. Okay, Gideon just looked irresistible, so she ended up buying him, and the rest is history. Gideon is a metallic briefcase. Rain Gordon, who works as a nursery school teacher, claims that her fascination with the inanimate objects began at a very young age. She has always believed that everything around her had a soul, and as time went by, her belief in animism only got stronger. In her early teenage years, she fell in love with a new shopping center that opened in her home city, but she knew people thought that was wrong, so she didn't tell anybody.
Wow, that's a strange one.
Yeah,
right?
She didn't tell anybody at all. Rain is now opening up about her love story with Gideon, the briefcase, in order to break down the misconceptions and stigma surrounding the romantic relationships with inanimate objects.
She falls in love with like objects.
One. Don't show her the Ninja Foodie Grill because she might want to fall in love with that, Bonnie.
Anybody would fall in love with a Ninja Foodie.
Yeah, that's true. Hi, good morning. You're on the air with Evan and Bonnie. Who's this? Okay, let's try another line here. Let's try this line.
Hello.
Hi, you're on the air with Evan and Bonnie. Good morning, and who's this?
Good morning, sir. What time would you like your pizza this morning?
Oh, it's Bentley, our butler.
He doesn't want the full pizza. He just wants the ring around
the
Bentley.
No, I don't want the ring around the pizza, Bentley. I want the whole damn pizza.
You can get me the ring and get it with marinara sauce.
Just marinara sauce and any cheese. Almighty God, it's a radio.
All of the cheese that you can find.
All right, so Bentley... you can partake in our contest this morning where you can win a Ellie's Deli gift certificate. Can you tell us a good joke, a one-line good joke or two-line good joke?
I guess a pizza is like a Frisbee. Hey-o.
Your joke is as plain as your idea
of what toast is. Yeah.
Yes, I'm actually sitting here looking at the birds outside. They have too much color. I like the white birds. And I'm just sitting here having my plain toast.
Oh, my gosh. Are you drinking coffee this morning?
Yeah, just black coffee.
Black coffee. Well, that's something
black coffee.
That's something you and Bonnie have because Bonnie loves black coffee.
Yeah,
plain black coffee.
Plain Jane black coffee drinker over here.
All right.
Yes.
All right. Well, Bentley, if you want to bring us a pizza this morning, you'll have
what
to wait.
What would you like on
open.
The pizza, sir?
I just like cheese. You know what I could really go for is a good barbecue pizza. I have not had a good barbecue pizza in forever and a day.
Do you like
well,
to...
you know Fredo has his barbecue and foot massage now and get the barbecue sauce from him, sir.
Oh, okay.
That foot massage along with barbecue sauce just doesn't sound right. That just doesn't sound very appetizing. Do you like a little sweet pineapple on that barbecue pizza, Evan?
You know, I don't know.
That's good. That's a good combination.
What did you say? What?
Pineapple?
Yeah, I'll take some pineapple.
Pineapple on like a barbecue chicken pizza. Have you had that before?
I'll take that.
It's an interesting combination.
I'll take that. Fredo, what about you?
Fredo's not here, sir.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. I got messed up. I thought I was I'm sorry. I thought Fredo was joining us on the line. For some reason, Fredo must have got disconnected because I got a text message that said he's calling in. So I went to answer the phone at the same time you're on the line, and he's not there. So obviously we got disconnected.
So many calls. We're getting confused. Who's calling?
This whole new phone system has got me bedazzled.
Yeah.
It's too complicated, sir. I like a plain phone where you just pick it up and talk, sir.
Yeah, that's true. I like a plain phone also. All right, very good. I wish I had a plain phone. All right, Bentley, well, thank you very much. I appreciate you, and I hope you have a marvelous day. And please give Big Kitty a big hug for us, if you would.
Yes, I have to go pick up Big Kitty today. I got to shave the kitty today, sir.
Okay, very good. The kitty has too much fur. You have to shave the kitty.
Save the kitty, yes.
Oh, save the kitty. You have to go save the kitty. I'm sorry. My bad. All right. Well, go save or shave or whatever you're going to do to the kitty. Just, you know, take care of you know, Big Kitty for us and make sure that the cat is well fed.
Yes, sir.
All right. Have a great day. Bye-bye now.
Bye.
All right. Very good. That's Bentley, our esteemed butler.
Yeah. He brings us good things once in a while.
He does.
Yeah. He keeps us well fed.
He does. He keeps us extremely, very, very, very well-fed. Okay, let me see here. On Friday night, two 27-year-old guys broke into a house in Sarnia, Ontario, Canada, by smashing the door with a hammer. Then one of them held a hammer over the people inside and demanded the money they owed him. But the guys quickly figured out that they'd broken into the wrong house. And these people didn't actually owe them any money at all.
Oh, yeah.
So they did what any good Canadians would do, and they apologized and offered to pay for the damages. So we're pretty sure that the people in the house didn't take them up on their offer and call the cops, but both of the guys were arrested on several charges.
Yeah, mm-hmm. As they should be.
Not a good thing.
No.
A 26-year-old guy named Alice Sweet went into a McDonald's in Portland, Maine on Tuesday last week after he had left home. He carried a chainsaw when he walked into McDonald's.
Really?
Yeah. Then he went behind the counter and stole a drink and some food while he revved up the chainsaw.
He probably wanted to slice his own burger and pickles.
Yeah. Then he went out into the parking lot where the manager confronted him, and the guy started chasing the manager with the chainsaw. Fortunately, nobody was hurt, and the guy was arrested for robbery and several other charges.
Yikes. Could you imagine to be a patron in McDonald's at that time?
Yeah.
Some guy walks in wielding a chainsaw.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Very different.
It's like, what would you be thinking? That would be complete chaos.
Lastly, an on-duty L.A. County Sheriff's deputy allegedly had sex with a woman near the Bates Hotel area of Universal Studios lot and somehow left his microphone on during the whole entire encounter.
Gosh.
Oh, yeah. The whole ordeal was overheard by a female police dispatcher. The dispatcher alerted the deputy after hearing a woman moaning and breathing very heavy. The deputy was not identified, but he was removed from duty and is being internally investigated, according to department officials.
Could you imagine... Were these during, like, operating hours, too?
And this guy was on duty.
Moms walking by with their kids and their children out in that area hearing that?
Well, you know about the Bates Motel. You've heard about the Bates Motel.
Yeah.
So, yeah, this happened in the area by the Bates Motel.
Mm-hmm.
And the cop was on duty, and he decides to do the hibbity-dibbity with whoever. And I guess while he was doing the hibbity-dibbity, the microphone on his police radio, the little dooflicky thing, was, I guess, pressed up against something, and it was activated. And the dispatcher heard everything that was going on.
Honestly.
One Adam 12, one Adam 12. Shh, we have a 211 in progress. One Adam 12, shh, code blue. Wow.
Yeah.
That's just not good.
That's creepy.
That's very, very creepy. I would not want to hear that over my police radio. 7:45. It's news time once again, and let's go to the news desk where Bonnie is standing by. Good morning, Bonnie.
Good morning, Evan. The Republican National Committee begins its in-person winter meeting at Amelia Island today. There's a lot on the agenda, with some Republicans planning to object as Congress moves to ratify results of the presidential election tomorrow.
I can't guarantee you, obviously, every senior is going to be able to get vaccinated tomorrow or the next day, but I can guarantee you, as long as we keep getting in, that's going to be the priority, and we want to get it done as soon as possible.
All Florida seniors are encouraged to get the coronavirus vaccine, but Governor Ron DeSantis says they'll need to be patient.
Our senior population deserves to be the priority. We were the first to come out of the gate on that. We've had Texas and I think Louisiana, Georgia, Colorado has followed suit.
DeSantis says they're pushing doses of the vaccine out to hospitals and local health departments as soon as they arrive. He says some COVID testing sites and houses of worship will be converted into inoculation locations to speed up the rollout of the vaccine. The Florida Department of Health in Martin County on Monday began administering the COVID-19 vaccine to people 65 and older. A long line of cars could be seen early Monday morning outside the health department's main office in Stewart as seniors waited to receive the vaccine produced by Moderna. Martin County health officials began making appointments last Tuesday for people 65 and older and quickly experienced an overwhelming volume of calls. Officials said all appointments are currently booked this week and more appointments will reopen once there is more supply of the Moderna COVID-19 vaccine. Officials said 800 people are expected to be vaccinated at the health department this week. The health department received about 34,000 calls in just 4 days last week for an appointment. Hospitals now have to disclose the rates they previously negotiate with insurers under a Trump administration rule that took effect Friday. While President Donald Trump has boasted that the historic measure will save patients money, health policy experts aren't so sure, and hospitals which unsuccessfully fought the rule in court says it's an extra burden on them while they're battling the coronavirus. The effort stems from an executive order Trump issued in 2019. The administration argues that such price transparency will allow patients to shop for lower-priced medical services and help reduce health care costs overall, one of the president's main promises during his campaigns and while in office. A growing number of Republican lawmakers have joined President Donald Trump's extraordinary effort to overturn the election, pledging to reject the results when Congress meets this week to count the Electoral College votes and certify President-elect Joe Biden's win. U.S. Representative Brian Mast, who represents Florida's 18th district, has joined that list. Mast, whose district includes Fort Pierce, Port St. Lucie, Stewart, and Jupiter, spoke Monday with WPTV anchor Michael Williams about why he is taking this stance. Quoting, "The goal is to not disenfranchise millions of Americans, to make sure that people know on both sides of the aisle or anywhere that it was a free, fair, honest election. And what we're looking at with the Electoral College and individual states being certified by the House of Representatives and the Senate, that is part of that process that strengthens that process," Mast said. McDonald's is launching new sandwiches next month in an effort to win fast food's chicken war. On Monday, the company announced three versions of a new chicken sandwich that will be available nationally on February 24. The crispy, crispy chicken sandwich topped with pickles and served on a potato roll, the spicy chicken sandwich that adds a spicy pepper sauce, and the deluxe chicken sandwich that comes with lettuce, tomatoes, and mayo. And lastly, Florida drivers are beginning the new year with much lower prices at the pump than they saw to begin 2020, 33 cents a gallon lower than this time a year ago to $2.19. AAA says gas prices averaged $2.11 for all of 2020, and that's the lowest yearly average in 16 years. The 2021 NCAA Division I men's basketball tournament will be played entirely in a bubble format in Indianapolis and surrounding areas. The NCAA announced this yesterday. The NCAA also announced that Selection Sunday will take place on March 14 and that the Final Four will be held on April 3, with the championship game being held on April 5. Our news time is 7:51. We'll have weather and traffic together next.
I stepped into St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins, I figured it would just be one of my many stops on my road to the perfect engagement ring. My fiancé means the world to me, so I wanted something extra special. I found a huge selection of engagement rings at great prices, and my worry about finding the perfect engagement ring was quickly replaced with exceptional customer service. St. Lucie Jewelry's over 400 five-star reviews really told the story. I finally picked a ring, and it was perfect. She was floored. And then the tears came.
Hi, this is Hawk Levy, owner of St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins. We're now celebrating 26 years, voted best diamond dealers, best jewelry buyers, and best jeweler year after year. Come celebrate with us in opening our third location at 1335 St. Lucie West Boulevard next to Publix. We invite you to take a tour of our competition, but then come see us last.
7:52 on the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie. It's a blended show this morning. G and Ray on vacation. They'll be back next week. It's time for traffic and weather together. It's all brought to you by Code Red Roofers. Bonnie?
And we do see an accident right now in Vero Beach. This is at Oslo Road and US 1 right in Vero Beach. Not showing any roadblock from that accident. And also we're showing a situation where there's some debris in the roadway. This is on the turnpike northbound, mile marker 147 in Port St. Lucie, where there's some metal debris in the left lane. So use caution in that area. And I guess if you see something, say something too, feel free to call us right here at 220-9788. Right now it's 48 in Port St. Lucie, and in Temuco, Chile, this morning it's 58. Here's our weather at WPTV.
It's a cold start to the morning along the Treasure Coast. Temperatures starting off in the 40s under mostly clear skies. This afternoon, highs in the low 70s, mostly sunny skies and light northwesterly winds. Tomorrow morning, another cold start to the day. Temperatures dropping to the 40s tonight. Highs in the low 70s once again with abundant sunshine. Thursday, temperatures return to average. Morning lows in the mid-50s and highs in the mid-70s. Friday, isolated rainfall possible as another cold front makes its way down the state.
I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Katya Hall on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
Here with Hillmore Optical. We have opened our office at a reduced capacity. We will continue to do eye exams, contact lenses, eyeglasses, and any repairs that you may need. We do ask that you wear a mask when you enter the office, as we are working very hard to keep everything clean and sanitized. We appreciate your patience during this long period and look forward to seeing you.
At St. Lucie Battery and Tire, we're here to take care of all of your automotive service needs. Now we have doubled your warranty on all parts and service. We stand behind our work and it shows. Plus now our warranty is good nationwide. Go to slbt.com and schedule your appointment. We will get you in and out so you can get back to what's most important. St. Lucie Battery and Tire, serving our customers' battery, tire, and service needs for nearly 50 years in the home of honest, reliable service.
The Slam Body Laser Spa, the wait is over.
What are you waiting for? Call the Slim Body Laser Spa and Stewart today and start losing inches today. That's right, lose belly fat, your double chin, flabby thighs, upper arm fat. Well, you get the picture. In a short series of laser-assisted weight loss treatments, you can lose inches of unwanted fat. Call 223-5885.
The Slam Body Laser Spa, the wait is over.
Weight, feel great and look fantastic with a little help from Dr. Fred J. Rezacker of Slim Body Laser Spa, East Ocean Boulevard in Stewart. And they're online. Visit their website, slimbodylaser.com. In a few short treatments, you'll see results. Lose 3, 6, even 9 inches of unwanted belly fat. The wait is over. Call today, 223-5885. That's 223-5885.
The Slim Body Laser Spa, the wait is over.
Today in Ag News from a Southeast Ag Network, Governor Ron DeSantis earlier this week did back a controversial reservoir being built in the Everglades while announcing the state will use a pool of environmental money to help Miami-Dade County protect Biscayne Bay from continued degradation. According to the News Service of Florida, DeSantis said his office will continue to support the $1.6 billion Everglades Agricultural Area Reservoir, which was approved by the legislature back in 2017. But it's recently been questioned by new Senate President Wilton Simpson. DeSantis addressed the issue as he outlined plans to provide $10 million match for local efforts to restore Biscayne Bay. Simpson described the man-made lagoon intended to redirect water south from Lake Okeechobee as a mistake. He became president last month, added that his farmers face a $3 billion to $4 billion shortfall in the next budget, and the state probably should stop building the reservoir. The 2017 law does provide $64 million a year for the reservoir, requiring that it be built on state-owned land rather than private farmland in the Everglades Ag area. The law also allows Florida to boost funding for the work by issuing up to $800 million in bonds. The state anticipates half of the funding for the work will come from the federal government. DeSantis called the reservoir one of the most important Everglades restoration projects in history. More of this story can be found on our website, southeastagnet.com.
Smart shoppers will tell you they found it on HiBid.com. HiBid.com lets you explore thousands of auctions across the U.S. and around the world. You'll find gold coins, sporting goods, classic cars, collectible toys, fine jewelry, household items, and sports memorabilia autographed by the greats. HiBid.com has hundreds of thousands of items for sale every day. It's easy to search, and it's easy to find auctions in your area. Just go to HiBid.com. That's HiBid.com. And see what everyone is talking about.
Randall Wiseman, Southeast Agnet.
You're listening to the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie on Martin County's Heritage Station, AM 1450 WSTU. Now let's get back to the program with Evan and Bonnie.
.758 on the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie. Fredo and the Shy Guys and our band in the other room playing up the tunes. Thank you so much for listening in. We're a blended show this morning. G and Ray on vacation. A much-needed recharging of the batteries, so to speak.
I have to call one of them or both of them to find out what they're doing.
Don't bother them.
Do I dare
they're
bother
on vacation.
Them?
No. No, don't even think about that.
I want to make sure they're enjoying it.
I'm sure they are. G's probably on the West Coast with a piña colada sitting on the beach getting a suntan.
Oh, that's where we want to be, don't
yeah.
we? It'll be a while before we can sit on the beach yeah. and get that suntan going.
Definitely.
Feeling
so.
Like winter here this morning.
We're WSTU Stewart, Martin County's Heritage Station, and WPSL Port St. Lucie, the talk of the Treasure Coast, a blended show this morning. We'll be back right after the news. Don't you dare go anywhere. In the meantime, enjoy the Get Up and Go Show band, Fredo and the Shy Guys.
Georgia. I'm Dave Anthony, Fox News. On the ballot, two runoff elections that will determine which party controls the Senate.
By electing John and the Reverend, you'll be sending a powerful message to Congress and to the country that it's time for this nation, for God's sake, to finally come together.
President-elect Biden rallying in Atlanta for John Ossoff and Raphael Warnock, the Democrats trying to defeat Senator Kelly Loeffler and David Perdue, who's trying to return to the Senate. President Trump rallied for them last night in Dalton, Georgia, urging Republicans to vote.
Those of you that know how badly screwed we got, I want to be clear that we can't let that happen again.
Fox's Evan Brown was there, now live in Atlanta.
Yeah, Dave, thousands braved the cold last night for the president's outdoor rally where he pushed people to vote for the GOP candidates. And his supporters say they will, but many, like Tom Corneliuson, say they support the president, but they're skeptical their vote will count.
It could be the last president in my lifetime that I get to support that I can believe in, because if they're going to allow cheating like in the last election, it won't matter anymore. We won't be in a democratic society any longer.
More than 3 million have already voted through absentee balloting or early voting, but millions more are expected to do so today, Dave.
Even more than 100 Republicans plan to object to the Electoral College vote certification tomorrow, Senator Josh Hawley told Fox.
I have heard from people like I've never heard before over the last month about this election. They have major, major concerns about the integrity, the fairness of this election, and they expect me to stand up and to raise those concerns.
Democratic Congressman James Clyburn calls it just shenanigans.
It's best when you have a process that has already unfolded. We've had each state to verify all of its results.
America's listening to Fox News.
Newsmax TV is the biggest thing on cable news, with shows including Dick Morris, Rudy Giuliani, Michelle Malkin, Diamond and Silk, Mike Huckabee, Alan Dershowitz, and more. Every night, watch Newsmax's number one show, Greg Kelly Reports. Greg Kelly tells you the truth about Trump. Newsmax is on all major cable systems. Check your guide or tell your operator you want Newsmax. 30 million Americans watch Newsmax TV. And download the Newsmax app on your smartphone. It's free. So get Newsmax TV anytime, anywhere.
You know where you were when the Golden State Killer was arrested. You're a moderator on the Zodiac Killer subreddit. But now you're in search of a new challenge. Enter Solve, the hit podcast that puts you at the center of the investigation. Solve is like no other murder mystery podcast. You'll track down killers hiding in plain sight.
You all right?
Yeah, it's just disturbing. Have you ever seen anything like this before?
Not like this.
Listen to Solve wherever you get your podcasts.
When Congress convenes tomorrow to certify the Electoral College vote giving Joe Biden the presidency, it's not just 100-plus Republicans who plan to object. Protests are planned around Washington.
D.C. Mayor Muriel Bowser has requested National Guard troops to support local police during this week. Acting Defense Secretary Christopher Miller is activating 340 personnel beginning today for crowd control at subway stations and to assist with street closures. Thousands of supporters of President Trump and counter-protesters are expected to demonstrate around the city, including near the White House and on Capitol Hill tomorrow during a joint session of Congress to count the Electoral College vote. In Washington, Jared Halpern, Fox News.
The National Guard also activated in Wisconsin, preparing for more protests there over the shooting of a black man back in August of last year. Prosecutors are getting ready to announce if the white police officer will be charged for wounding Jacob Blake while responding to a domestic dispute. Concrete barricades and fencing now up around a Kenosha courthouse. It is the dead of winter, with much of the country cold and frozen. A warning to kids who love to eat snow and ice went viral.
Katie Nicolau, a meteorologist in Sioux City, Iowa, sharing a TikTok video commenting on clips of folks eating icicles, explaining,
when icicles form, it's from water that melts off of your roof and runs down the side of a building. Well, here's the thing. You know what else is on your roof? Bird poop. A lot of it. And that water picks it up and freezes it in the ice.
Her stomach-churning winter warning earning millions of views. Kristen Goodwin, Fox News.
On Wall Street, stock futures were up earlier, now down slightly the morning after a sell-off started the new year. The Dow plunged nearly 400 points, the Nasdaq down almost 200. I'm Dave Anthony. This is Fox News.
Hello, this is Gary Owen of the Owen Insurance Group. We are a local independent insurance agency located right here on the Treasure Coast. I've been a resident here for 34 years and have helped thousands of clients with their insurance planning needs. We specialize in life, health, and Medicare insurance planning. Don't travel the road alone. Let us be your guide. We are the Owen Insurance Group. Contact us today at 772-210-1020 or visit our website at oweninsurancegroup.net.
No hype, just facts. I'm KC, and I invite you to tune into the KC Ingram Show every Tuesday from 5 to 6 p.m. Hear from community leaders, learn about some of our great local nonprofit organizations, get the latest updates from our elected officials, and meet the candidates. Even rock and roll legends have joined the show from time to time. I'm conservative, but not divisive, bringing you the talk of the community. It's a fun and interesting hour beginning at 5 p.m. every Tuesday on WSTU AM 1450 and Facebook Live at the Casey Ingram Show.
Unfortunately, in today's litigious society, too many Americans fail to have an effective estate plan and asset protection strategy. I'm attorney TJ Heineman, and I've been counseling families, businesses, and executives for 20 years. I can help you preserve your wealth, safeguard your assets, and protect your family. My law firm specializes in estate planning and administration, asset protection, corporate law, and real estate. For a free copy of my Family Estate Planning Survival Guide or a free consultation in my Palm City office, call me, TJ Heineman, at 888-5667.
Coming to you live from Stuart, Florida, the greatest little town in the world. It's the Get Up and Go Show on AM 1450 WSTU. You're invited to call the show anytime at 772-220-9788. And now, broadcasting live from their palatial studios, here are your hosts, Evan and Bonnie.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Announcer. It's the Get Up and Go Show 807. We are a blended show this morning. And you know when you hear that music, it gets serious. Because joining us on the line right now, in place of Sheriff William Snyder, who is getting sworn in today for the umpteenth time.
Isn't that a great matter? That
it
is serious, folks.
It's serious stuff.
Yes.
Because
very
serious. He's the people's sheriff. Just like The Rock is the people's champ. Well, Sheriff William Snyder is the people's sheriff. So could you imagine the sheriff going up against The Rock in a match? That would be amazing. Wouldn't it, John?
It would be amazing. Probably give him a run for his money. Absolutely.
Oh, my gosh. Anyway, Major John Budensiek joining us on our line right now from the Martin County Sheriff's Office. He is pinch hitting for the sheriff this morning, who is getting sworn in again. How many times is it now, John?
This is his third term that he's entering
wow.
into now.
So that's 12 years.
Beautiful.
Yes.
Wow. Okay. That's a good thing.
It is a good thing. I spent 16 years with Sheriff Crowder. He had 20 years total, but it's a good thing for the sheriff's office for sure, and then the county, not to have turnover every 4 years.
Yeah, consistency is very good in law enforcement.
It is. Absolutely.
That's for sure. So let's talk a little bit about some of Sheriff Snyder's goals and some of his accomplishments over the last 12 years, if you would.
Wow. Well,
I know you could write a book on that.
We could. The sheriff's one of those guys that never sleeps or slumbers. If he's up and about, he's thinking of something new, or he's reading a national trend or trying to figure out how we can do it, not only do it, but do it better. So he has created, under his watch, all kinds of different programs.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll launch into a few of them, but I'm going to miss most of them.
We'd need a whole 3 hours to cover everything.
We could probably do 3 hours.
Right?
Probably do 3 hours. But he has captured crime data. He's broken down the silos within the sheriff's office, making sure that we're sharing crime data. And part of that is a program called MCI, Martin County Intelligence, where we every week mine out all the data of the crimes that have taken place, try to get ahead of them for the next week or whenever we think they're going to actually take place. Instead of being a reactive agency, we're trying to be a proactive agency by analyzing the crime and the trends,
mm-hmm.
and then trying to be there and intercept the crime as it actually happens. With that, he has put us in the 21st century of real enhanced AI crime-fighting tools. So we're not having to have a body in all places at all times. We can actually use surveillance, we hope, to the best of its means in order to be successful. Implemented an ESRI program, which ESRI is a kind of a broad term for a computer system, and I'm not a tech guy, so I'm not like you, Evan.
Right.
So I won't delve down into it too deep, but ESRI allows or will allow our dispatchers to see where the call is on the screen and exactly where the nearest deputy is, so the dispatcher can move that deputy, be it a detective or a deputy in a patrol car, to the call more efficiently.
I think that's kind of like geo-tracking.
It is. Yeah, it's very similar to that.
Right.
But it allows there to be a big screen, and dispatch can always know where the players are. It's kind of like a football coach
moving
their people around on the board. So, you there, Evan? Did I lose you?
No, I'm here. I'm here. I'm letting you talk about the accomplishments and all the different things.
Another thing and you've seen it probably on our Facebook, certainly on the news, we've got a lot of technology on our helicopter now, and we're in the middle of purchasing another helicopter, a brand new helicopter that should be here in June. But with that, the night vision, the camera capabilities on that helicopter, we'll be able to pipe that right into our sheriff's office and watch what they're doing live and assist with manhunts. And, of course, we use the helicopter to... We talked about it a couple of weeks ago. You know, a car chase, a helicopter can just set up there and follow these people home as opposed to chase them through the middle of Stewart.
Right.
Our traffic at 100 miles an hour.
Right, exactly. And, you know, especially the night vision on these helicopters are really amazing. I had a friend of mine once who had a pair of night vision goggles. And he goes, here, try these on and go in a dark room for a minute. And it was nighttime. And we were outside and... it was pitch black outside, and as soon as I looked through his night vision binoculars, I was like, wow, that's like daylight.
Did everything look all kind of like a yellow, kind of like a image?
It's hard to explain the color. I want to say it was kind of monochrome, if that's the right word to use, monochrome-ish. And it was like daylight.
I could imagine that sort of technology would be really good, like if somebody was missing too, like in the woods.
Yeah.
You know, like in St. Lucie County, they had the missing children recently.
And, well, that's why they have
a drone found them.
Right. That's why they have the helicopters that have the night vision. And they also have another thing that's called heat sinking. Right, John?
Yeah. Infrared and we can sense heat out of the helicopter.
Yeah.
Which is really what they operate a lot of times on at night. You know, everything's hot and cold, so it comes across as black and white.
Mm-hmm.
It really is helpful, especially looking for missing people who aren't trying to hide from you. They're out in the middle of the woods, you know, trying to wave you down. That helicopter picks them up in minutes, whereas it would take hours, maybe sometimes days, to find somebody in the middle of a rural area.
Now, today's going to be a very special swearing-in ceremony because the sheriff's son is going to be swearing him in, and he's also our local state representative.
He is, and that's neat to me because the state rep, who is my state rep in District 82, is recently elected, and he's been around the sheriff's office in Martin County since we were all kids.
Mm-hmm.
And, he obviously has grown up in a law enforcement household, has a strong passion for what law enforcement does, and he's already hit the ground running trying to enact legislation that protects Martin County and the counties around Florida from traveling criminals. So I'm very excited to spend some time with Representative Snyder, and I think it'll be a neat, for lack of a better word, a neat swearing in, kind of a generational thing today. I know I'm stuttering a little bit there, but you know what I'm trying to say.
No, that's okay. That's perfectly fine. He's actually going to be on the program on the 22nd of this month, and he'll actually be live in studio. Our local state representative, John Snyder, who is Sheriff William Snyder's son, he's going to be here with us. We'll spend about a half hour with him and talk about some different things and on the way he looks at things for 2021.
Yeah, we can't wait to meet him, too.
Yeah, he's a really super, super nice guy. John, I want to talk a little bit about some of the more significant cases that the Martin County Sheriff's Office has covered. Let's start first with Trisha Todd.
Trisha Todd is unique. unfortunately, we had to work that case. But what was unique about Trisha Todd was both the sheriff and I are personal friends with her family, and we were prior to her abduction and homicide.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I talked to Trish Todd the day, now we know, the day that she came up missing. I saw her in Publix up in Tradition and said hi to her and, you know, the normal pleasantries, obviously not having a clue what was fixing to happen to her.
Right.
But that case, while it was extremely complex, had a very personal part to the sheriff. And like I said to myself also, because we were dealing with the family from a, you know, we're always empathetic, but this was a whole other level of empathy.
Mm-hmm.
And a whole other level of, you know, bound and determined to make sure that we arrested Mr. Williams and brought him to justice, you know, not knowing it was him at the time. But that case was a nightmare case for the sheriff, for sure, and for the sheriff's office. Going into it, not having a clear suspect, not having a lot of information to work off of, but our detectives, under the direction of the sheriff, they went to work, and they did not rest until they figured it out.
That's...
And that was with the support of the community. I mean, if you were tracking with what was going on back then, there were people from all over the county down in Hope Sound searching every patch of woods down there that there was, that there is.
I remember it, definitely.
Yes.
Let's talk a little bit about Andrea Parsons. That's another one that sticks out to me.
So Andrea Parsons, that case began when the sheriff was the captain in charge of the criminal investigations division under Sheriff Crowder's watch.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, Sheriff Snyder carried that case as a CID captain, as a detective's captain, all the way through until he got promoted to major, was a director of law enforcement. He carried that case with him until it was solved. It was actually solved at the end of Sheriff Crowder's term.
Mm-hmm.
But Sheriff Snyder had an enormous amount of influence in that case, and his investigative skills and the way he directed it helped bring that case to a successful conclusion. Unfortunately, we still have not found her. We have every lead that we have had. We've tracked it down. We have excavated the landfill, numerous pieces of property around Martin County, looking mm-hmm. for her, looking for her remains. We have not been successful. But like I said, we were able to successfully arrest some defendants in the case and got partial closure. We never will have total closure, and it still does haunt all of us until we find her herself.
Right, exactly. And lastly, the one that really sticks out the most, that really hits home, is the unfortunate death of Trooper Bullock.
You know, the sheriff said many times that's something, you know, dealing with a dead law enforcement officer in Martin County, something that he never wants to deal with.
Yeah.
Prayed over that would never happen. But unfortunately, it did happen with Joe Bullock, and, you know, he rallied the troops, and, you know, we know what the mission is, and we know why we're out there, and it was a reminder how dangerous the job is. And, you know, we still do work with the Florida Highway Patrol. You know, we're coming up on his anniversary next month.
Can't believe that.
Yeah, it's been a year already. But, you know, those were tough times going through, you know, standing on the side of I-95, looking at a friend, a coworker, who was just out there trying to help somebody out and then senselessly lost his life. Yes, we were able to solve it. Yes, it was a complex case, and yes, kudos to the sheriff, but it still doesn't bring Trooper Bullock back.
No.
The whole in Martin County and in the law enforcement community.
Not at all. And then, of course, you know, 2021, we're already off to a running start. And unfortunately, I'm sure it's still under investigation where, if I remember correctly, and correct me if I'm wrong, the son shot his father.
Yes, sir. That happened over the weekend. We did start off busy this year already with a couple of pursuits. I know we talked about them a couple of weeks ago. We had
right.
the shooting. I lose track of days, but I believe it was Friday night into Saturday morning.
Mm-hmm.
We do have the suspect in custody, and right now the victim seems to be in stable condition, so hopefully he pulls through and is okay. And on the legal side, I know the state attorney will will kick in and do their job to make sure that this doesn't happen again.
Yeah, that when I read about that, and it brought me back to the other story about how the guy shot and killed his wife. He woke up in the middle of the night and thought it was a burglar, and he shot his wife. And that obviously, that is still under an investigation as well, correct?
It is. We're still waiting for some evidence to come in that case. We're not ready to make a final determination in that case, so we're a little ways out. But, you know, those cases that are confusing, we have to go really slow and be very careful and make sure that we don't miss a nuance or something that's out there that we just have not uncovered yet. So that case, just because of how complex it is and how sensitive it is, we've been careful and not gotten to the end of that one yet. It may take a little while still.
Gotcha. Our very special guest this morning is Major John Budensiek. He is the left and right hand man to Sheriff William Snyder. He's always here for us whenever the sheriff cannot be with us. And I know you got to get going because you've got a engagement that you have to MC this morning. It's the swearing in of Sheriff William Snyder for his third term this morning. Please give our best to Sheriff Snyder, if you would, John.
I will. And y'all have a good week, and thank you much.
No problem. God bless you and all the deputies in law enforcement there. Thank you so much for everything you guys do.
Thank you.
All right. Bye-bye now. News time right now. It's 8:21. Let's go to the news desk where Bonnie's standing by. Good morning, Bonnie.
Good morning, Evan. The Republican National Committee begins its in-person winter meeting at Amelia Island today. There's a lot on the agenda, with some Republicans planning to object as Congress moves to ratify results of the presidential election tomorrow.
Republicans are in a holding pattern right now to see what Donald Trump's going to do, how he exits office, and how he talks to his supporters, and what Donald Trump plans for the future.
The coronavirus death toll in Florida now topping 22,000. The Department of Health announcing 103 additional fatalities yesterday, along with more than 11,000 new cases. Florida continues to ramp up its COVID-19 vaccine program with a focus on getting senior citizens protected from the virus.
Our senior population deserves to be the priority. We were the first to come out of the gate on that. We've had Texas and I think Louisiana, Georgia, Colorado has followed suit.
Governor Ron DeSantis says the state will soon start working with churches in underserved communities to get the vaccine into more arms. Well, every Monday morning for the past 11 months, the Clean Water Coalition of Indian River County collects water samples from three locations near the Indian River Lagoon. What are they testing for? Harmful enteric bacteria, a sign of fecal pollution in water. In the past almost year of testing and analyzing the samples, the environmental group has found high levels of fecal matter in the lagoon. What we're trying to do is continue to bring awareness, said Paul Fafetta, president of the coalition. The lagoon is in sad shape, and there are a number of things that need to be done to help it along its way. And for the organization's 12 Days of Christmas wish, staff is asking for donations to continue the water sampling, which Fafeta said is a costly operation. Right now, volunteers do collect the samples from these locations, including Mac Williams Park, Dog Park just north of the Merrill P. Barber Bridge, the Vero Beach Wastewater Treatment Plant, and the Oslo Road Boat Ramp area. And here's how you can make a donation. You can mail them to the Clean Water Coalition, P.O. Box 690761, Vero Beach, 32969, or you can donate online too through cwcirc.org. Two missing children are now safe after police in Port St. Lucie used a drone to locate them on Sunday. Sergeant Keith Boehm said officers responded to the 2200 block of Southwest Almanar Street after receiving a report about the missing children. Police learned two families were having a play date when the children slipped out the front door. The children apparently went looking for their older siblings, who had just left for a ride on a recreational vehicle, according to Boehm. Boehm. Officers searched the area but could not locate the small children. Boehm said a police drone pilot and visual observer later responded to the scene and quickly located the two children walking along a lake near their home. The drone pilot hovered about the children, keeping watch over them until the family picked them up. The Florida Department of Health in Martin County on Monday began administering the COVID-19 vaccine to people 65 and older. A long line of cars could be seen early Monday morning outside the health department's main office in Stuart as seniors waited to receive the vaccine produced by Moderna. Martin County health officials began making appointments last Tuesday for people 65 and older and quickly experienced an overwhelming volume of calls. Officials said all appointments are currently booked this week, and more appointments will reopen once there is a more supply of the Moderna COVID-19 vaccine. Officials said 800 people are expected to be vaccinated at the health department this week. The health department received about 34,000 calls in just 4 days last week for an appointment. And lastly, the cast of The Waltons will reunite for the first Stars in the House reunion of 2021. Nearly all the surviving original cast members are on board, including Richard Thomas, John Boy, Michael Learned, Olivia, Mary Beth McDonough, Aaron, Eric Scott, Ben, Cammy Kotler, who played Elizabeth, and Judy Norton, Mary Ellen. That's basically everyone except John Wamsley, who played Jason, and David W. Harper, who played Jim Bob. It's unclear why they're not participating. Stars in the House is the YouTube series that started in the wake of the pandemic that benefits the Actors Fund. They've already done reunions for Knott's Landing, Frasier, and Glee. The Jacksonville Jaguars are firing head coach Doug Marrone. The Jags will have a busy offseason as they look for Marrone's replacement, hire a new general manager, and make the top pick in the NFL draft. Our news time is 8:27. We'll have weather and traffic together next.
I stepped into St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins, I figured it would just be one of my many stops on my road to the perfect engagement ring. My fiancé means the world to me, so I wanted something extra special. I found a huge selection of engagement rings at great prices, and my worry about finding the perfect engagement ring was quickly replaced with exceptional customer service. St. Lucie Jewelry's over 400 five-star reviews really told the story. I finally picked a ring, and it was perfect. She was floored. And then the tears came.
Hi, this is Hawk Levy, owner of St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins. We're now celebrating 26 years, voted best diamond dealers, best jewelry buyers, and best jeweler year after year. Come celebrate with us in opening our third location at 1335 St. Lucie West Boulevard next to Publix. We invite you to take a tour of our competition, but then come see us last.
A28, the time right now to get up and go show with Evan and Bonnie. It's a blended show. G and Ray on vacation until next week. It's time for traffic and weather together, all brought to you by Code Red Roofers. Bonnie?
Well, we do have one accident in Vero Beach. This is at Old Dixie Highway and Oslo Road in Vero Beach. Not any roadblocks showing from that accident. And that's your latest look at traffic. It's 51 in Palm City and in York, England this morning, 38. Here's our weather at WPTV.
It's a cold start to the morning along the Treasure Coast. Temperatures starting off in the 40s under mostly clear skies. This afternoon, highs in the low 70s, mostly sunny skies and light northwesterly winds. Tomorrow morning, another cold start to the day. Temperatures dropping to the 40s tonight. Highs in the low 70s once again with abundant sunshine. Thursday, temperatures return to average, morning lows in the mid-50s and highs in the mid-70s. Friday, isolated rainfall possible as another cold front makes its way down the state.
I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Katya Hall on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
weaker one. So if you incurred roof damage in the last 2 years, Code Red Roofers is there to help you with all of your roofing needs. Code Red Roofers, the roofers who respond 24/7. And there are flexible payment options for metal, tile, shingle, or flat roofs. Code Red Roofers, se habla español. Code Red Roofers, 844-4-CODE-RED. That's 844-4-CODE-RED.
Today's to-do list. Stop and get coffee. Go to work. Swing by the grocery store. Eat dinner. Go to sleep. Get up. Do it all over again. Seacoast believes spending time with your loved ones should be on your everyday to-do list. Seacoast Air Conditioning, family-owned and operated for over 38 years, knows the importance of family. Whether it's reading a bedtime story, sharing your day around the dinner table, or just picking up the phone and calling mom, these are the moments that are remembered for a lifetime.
Comfort crisis? Don't roast. Call Seacoast.
Hello, this is Gary Owen of the Owen Insurance Group. We are a local independent insurance agency located right here on the Treasure Coast. I've been a resident here for 34 years and have helped thousands of clients with their insurance planning needs. We specialize in life, health, and Medicare insurance planning. Don't travel the road alone. Let us be your guide. We are the Owen Insurance Group. Contact us today at 772-210-1020 or visit our website at oweninsurancegroup.net.
Are you looking for a career with good pay and growth opportunities? Then register today for Indian River State College's Certified Logistics Associate Training Program. Hi, I'm Joe Gorham with IRSC's Corporate and Community Training Institute. The CLA course provides students with the foundational and broad knowledge you will need to understand the world of distribution. The course includes training in the global supply chain, logistics environment, safe equipment operation, material handling equipment, quality control, workplace communication, teamwork, and problem solving. Upon completion, students will have the opportunity to earn a nationally recognized industry certification. Start your career path today and earn more in the dynamic field of distribution for companies like Amazon, Walmart, CVS, and others. For more information on the Lincoln Park Career Pathways Program, contact Melanie George at 462-7395. 462-7395.
Your reopening with the power of talk radio. WPSL and WSTU Digital on TuneIn Worldwide and on Alexa at home, car, tablet, or phone.
Do you have a suggestion for the show? Send us an email. WSTU Morning Show at gmail.com. And now let's get back to the Get Up and Go show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
8:33 right now, the Get Up and Go show with Evan and Bonnie. It's time for a look where not too many people get to go, only the privileged ones, and it's outer space with Randy Segal and our daily dose of space. Good morning, Randy. How are you?
I'm great, sir. How about yourself?
You know, life is good. Things are great. It's January the 5th, and do you know what's happening in 8 days from now?
No, what?
It's my one-year anniversary here.
A whole year has gone by already?
That fast. Just like the, you know, ISS goes around the Earth.
Just like it was yesterday,
just
Randy.
Just like it was yesterday.
Yep.
It's crazy.
Well, we're happy to have you.
Well, thank you. And we're happy to have you as well.
Why, thank you, sir. Well, believe it or not, there was nothing that happened in space history yesterday or today. So nothing to talk about as far as the historical side goes. But in new history that's being made, the astronauts on board the International Space Station are doing a tremendous amount of work that may benefit us here on Earth. Mike Hopkins and Victor Glover did several experiments with mice to help scientists work on preventing vision and bone condition problems with astronauts who live in space. Japanese astronaut Soichi Noguchi assisted with two life science experiments. One of the experiments on board is to look at cancer therapies in space. Kate Rubens looked at engineering heart tissues to gain insights into aging and weakening heart muscles that humans experience on and off the Earth. The crew also is getting ready to detach the Cygnus module that's been attached to the International Space Station now for about 93 days on the 6th. That will be shown on NASA TV. It is completely filled with trash, as well as several experiments that will go on before it actually reenters the Earth's atmosphere, even though the Canadarm2 robot arm will remove it from the Unity module. Tomorrow, it will remain in orbit on its own until January 26th. That's when it will be remotely controlled to enter the Earth's atmosphere and burn up over the Pacific Ocean without harming anybody. But it will give us a lot of good insight and information. We also note that on January the 11th, the cargo Dragon that's attached to the International Space Station will be released. And what makes it even more interesting is it'll be the first Dragon that it will have a splashdown in the Atlantic Ocean off the coast of Florida. Tomorrow evening, or the 8th, excuse me, on the 8th, SpaceX will launch its next satellite into orbit. SpaceX is scheduled to launch at about 8:23 p.m., where it will carry a Turkish satellite into orbit, giving Turkey a new communication satellite. As I said, that departure from the International Space Station of the Dragon will be the 21st resupply servicing mission that will be going home. The upgraded Dragon offers several features that the old Dragons did not. Namely, it can carry a larger payload to bring a lot of more experiments back. And some of the experiments that will be coming back and that are done are cardiac heart research, space organ genesis, sextant navigation, rodent research, thermal scrubbers, and bacterial adhesion and corrosion. So a lot going on that side. Gwen Shotwell, who is the president of SpaceX, said that they intend to launch a lot of rockets this year, and the majority of them will be second use or third or fifth use. The rockets and the Falcon 9 cadre are being recycled as they are being recovered. This saves SpaceX a lot of money on their launches and provides the customers for a cheaper way to get into space. That's not a bad way to do it, by using proven launchers. Virgin Orbit, the company that wants to launch satellites from underneath the wing of a specially crafted Boeing 747 known as Cosmic Girl, expects its first launch to take place in a launch window on January the 10th. You may recall that when they had their first test launch that took place last year, the rocket sputtered for a few seconds with its engine burn and then quit. As a result, the satellites were all lost. In this mission, they expect to carry up to 9 small satellites into orbit for new technology and conducting scientific and educational research. SpaceX also has been tasked by the Masten Space Systems to fly a mission to the moon. Masten's XS-1 lunar lander will be launched by a Falcon 9. That launch contract was given in April of last year. And later this year, they hope to land new payloads on the moon. This comes where China has already announced that their spacecraft brought back nearly 4 pounds of boulders and dust from the moon during their last mission. India says they're also getting ready to start flying advanced rockets that will be reusable, similar to what the Falcon 9 is doing. India has become a major player in space and wants to continue in that position. The top staff member of the National Space Council has resigned. Scott Pace announced his resignation as he intends to return to George Washington University, where he had served as director of its Space Policy Institute. Pace left the university in July of 2017 to lead the day-to-day operations of the council, which was chaired by Vice President Pence. Tomorrow we'll tell you more of what China intends to do and about Axiom Space going its own way for a space station. So until tomorrow, have a great day, everybody.
That's Randy Segal with a space report. He's on the program each and every weekday, Monday through Friday at around 8:30, catching us up on all things NASA. Time to head on over to Ellie's Downtown Deli, where Bonnie is standing by with some delectable treats to actually warm you up on a nice, cool Tuesday morning.
Yeah, like a hot bowl of soup, and Chef prepares these every day. I know yesterday, Evan, he did have some ham and potato soup.
Oh.
He's had some mac and cheese, beefy soup, too, in the past. And I think he even had like a Wisconsin style at one time, which included like a cheddar cheese with beer kind of soup. He puts all of these amazing ingredients into what he prepares. And, you know, always going good with a signature sandwich.
Yeah.
Like the Southwest Club. Enjoy it with oven gold turkey, smoked bacon, spicy cilantro mayo, tomatoes, and lettuce on a toasted wheat. You can get the double decker today, too, for lunch. Some hot corned beef packed with pastrami. Swiss cheese on it goes oh so good on toasted rye bread with sauerkraut, blue cheese dressing, and tomatoes. Enjoy your sandwiches with a salad today with a signature side. And for the kids, take home some Andy's Candies fudge brownies. Oh, the kids will delight in that tonight.
Mm-mm.
Ellie's Downtown Deli and Stewart now has their patio back open. Plus, they're at 50% dining inside with a full menu for pickup or delivery. Ellie's also has full dinners available for takeout, plus their fabulous desserts as well. Call 772-785-6605 to order and pick up today. Located at 18 Southeast 6th Street, just off Colorado in Stewart. Call 772-781-6605. Ellie's Downtown Deli in Stewart.
Time for the Precious Metals Report. It's all brought to you by St. Lucie Jewelry and Coin. Gold opening up this morning at $1,949 an ounce, and silver opening up at $27.37 an ounce. That's the Precious Metals Report, and it's all brought to you by St. Lucie Jewelry and Coin. 8:43 right now. News time once again on a blended show this morning. G and Ray on vacation next week. Let's go to the news desk, and here's Bonnie.
Thanks once again, Evan. And two local members of Congress are challenging the election of President-elect Joe Biden, joining more than 100 Republicans who are casting doubt over the results. This despite state and federal courts, state election officials and federal officials rejecting accusations of widespread fraud in the November 3 election. Representatives Bill Posey and Brian Mast, representing the Treasure and Space Coast, insists on an investigation into the results of the election. They represent mostly conservative counties and the red-swinging St. Lucie County. Few members of Congress have been more aggressive than Posey in calling for investigations into the results of the election. I will not turn a blind eye to this election found fraud, rather, on January 6th, Posey tweeted on New Year's Eve. all Florida seniors actually, all Florida seniors are encouraged to get the coronavirus vaccine, but Governor Ron DeSantis says they'll need to be patient.
I can't guarantee you, obviously, every senior is going to be able to get vaccinated tomorrow or the next day, but I can guarantee you, as long as we keep getting in, that's going to be the priority, and we want to get it done as soon as possible.
DeSantis says they are pushing doses of the vaccine out to hospitals and local health departments as soon as they arrive. He says some COVID testing sites and houses of worship will be converted into inoculation locations to speed up the rollout of the vaccine. Many Florida seniors who have been vaccinated against COVID are thinking of others as they roll up their sleeves, says Seminole County Health Director Donna Walsh.
It's interesting, as people have come through to get their vaccine, 65 years of age and older, many have asked, how can I volunteer? How can I help you? These are retired nurses. These are people who aren't even in the medical field. So thank you for that.
Walsh says they've taken down names and those people will be deployed in teams out in the community to get the vaccine safely into as many arms as possible, as soon as possible. Tanya Roberts, who captivated James Bond in A View to a Kill and later played Midge Pinciotti in the sitcom That 70s Show, was hospitalized after falling at her home. The actor had mistakenly been reported dead by her publicist earlier Monday. Roberts' publicist, Mike Pingle, later told the Associated Press on Monday that Roberts, age 65, was still alive as of 10 a.m. Pacific time, but was in poor condition. He had said earlier Monday that Roberts collapsed in her home Sunday and was admitted to Senior Side Eye Medical Center. Multiple media outlets reported Roberts' death. Florida drivers are beginning the new year with much lower prices at the pump than they saw to begin 2020, 33 cents a gallon lower than this time a year ago to 2.19, and AAA says gas prices averaged 2.11 for all of 2020. That's the lowest average in 16 years. And the Florida Department of Health in Martin County on Monday began administering the COVID-19 vaccine to people 65 and older. A long line of cars could be seen early yesterday morning outside the health department's main office in Stewart as seniors waited to receive the vaccine produced by Moderna. Martin County health officials began making appointments last Tuesday for people 65 and older and quickly experienced an overwhelming volume of calls. Officials said all appointments are currently booked this week, and more appointments will reopen once there is more supply of the Moderna COVID-19 vaccine. Officials said 800 people are expected to be vaccinated at the health department this week. The health department received about 34,000 calls in just 4 days last week for an appointment. And now we take a look at sports. In his three-time NBA title-winning career, Steph Curry has put in some dominant performances. However, he might have eclipsed them all on Sunday night in the Golden State Warriors' 137-122 win over the Portland Trail Blazers. Curry scored a career-high 62 points in 36 minutes on the floor, finishing 18 for 31 from the field, 8 for 16 from three-point range, 18 of 19 from the free throw line, and had 5 rebounds and 4 assists. Afterwards, Curry called it a pretty crazy night. Curry's previous career high was 54 against the New York Knicks in February 2013. News Time 8:49. We'll have weather and traffic together next.
I stepped into St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins, I figured it would just be one of my many stops on my road to the perfect engagement ring. My fiance means the world to me, so I wanted something extra special. I found a huge selection of engagement rings at great prices, and my worry about finding the perfect engagement ring was quickly replaced with exceptional customer service. St. Lucie Jewelry's over 400 five-star reviews really told the story. I finally picked a ring, and it was perfect. She was floored. And then the tears came.
Hi, this is Hawk Levy, owner of St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins. We're now celebrating 26 years, voted best diamond dealers, best jewelry buyers, and best jeweler year after year. Come celebrate with us in opening our third location at 1335 St. Lucie West Boulevard next to Publix. We invite you to take a tour of our competition, but then come see us last.
.850 the time right now, the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie, a blended show. G and Ray on vacation. They'll be back next week. It's time for traffic and weather together. It's all brought to you by Code Red Roofers. Bonnie?
Well, we're looking at a nice ride on the roadways right here in Martin County, and looks like St. Lucie County, too. We don't have any traffic ties, nothing tied up on our major highways, and US 1 looking clear at the moment. Drive safely on this Tuesday. That's your latest look at traffic. It's 51 in Stewart, and in Brattleboro, Vermont this morning, 32. Here's our forecast at WPTV.
It's a cold start to the morning along the Treasure Coast. Temperatures starting off in the 40s under mostly clear skies. This afternoon, highs in the low 70s, mostly sunny skies and light northwesterly winds. Tomorrow morning, another cold start to the day. Temperatures dropping to the 40s tonight. Highs in the low 70s once again with abundant sunshine. Thursday, temperatures return to average, morning lows in the mid-50s and highs in the mid-70s. Friday, isolated rainfall possible as another cold front makes its way down the state.
I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Katya Hall on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
Unfortunately, in today's litigious society, too many Americans fail to have an effective estate plan and asset protection strategy. I'm attorney TJ Heineman, and I've been counseling families, businesses, and executives for 20 years. I can help you preserve your wealth, safeguard your assets, and protect your family. My law firm specializes in estate planning and administration, asset protection, corporate law, and real estate. For a free copy of my Family Estate Planning Survival Guide or a free consultation in my Palm City office, call me, TJ Heineman, at 888-5667.
Hi, this is Denny Artachi, host of the Today with Denny Show, where we talk about financial and healthy well-being from a common sense perspective. This is a show where we cover what's on your mind, like local, world, and entertainment news. So tune in, have fun, share your story Thursday mornings from 9 to 10 a.m. on WSTU 1450 AM radio.
At St. Lucie Battery and Tire, we're here to take care of all of your automotive service needs. Now we have doubled your warranty on all parts and service. We stand behind our work and it shows. Plus now our warranty is good nationwide. Go to slbt.com and schedule your appointment. We will get you in and out so you can get back to what's most important. St. Lucie Battery and Tire, serving our customers' battery, tire, and service needs for nearly 50 years in the home of honest, reliable service.
If you have a suggestion for the show, we would love to hear from you. Send us an email to wstumorningshow@gmail.com. Now let's get back to the Get Up and Go Show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
8:53, the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie. We have a phone call. We've had lots of calls this morning. Hi, you're on the air with Evan and Bonnie. Good morning, and who's this?
Good morning, guys. It's been a while.
Oh, Happy New Year, old man. How are you?
We're doing good. Edna and I decided we're going to stay in Florida until winter's over with. Too cold out there.
Okay, so what part of Florida are you in, old man?
Well, right now we're getting off of Becker Road.
Oh, no, please. No, just keep going further south if you would,
oh,
please.
Yeah, that's Evan's area.
That's my area. Oh, jeez. Great, he's going to park the Winnebago in my front yard. What I needed.
It's going to start to rust by mid-July, and it'll still be parked there.
I'm not going to be staying there for a while, so you're going to be there all alone, just so you know.
Well, you know, we got done. We were at Yeehaw Junction for a little bit.
Okay.
And, we're thinking about coming over that Roosevelt Bridge in a little while, too.
Oh, no, no. Now he's going to park the Winnebago in the parking lot of the Palatial Radio Studios.
You can't. I'm going to be
you
driving.
You can't do that.
I'll drive over that bridge in a few minutes. You cannot.
You can't do that.
Can't
you're
be
not
possible.
Allowed. Parking lot won't hold a Winnebago.
Off of our highways.
Well, I'm going to meet up with Fredo, and he's going to have his his tanning truck there.
Oh, the tanning truck, yes.
Oh, I thought you said a canning truck.
Yeah, canning truck.
You know, is he canning peppers or pickles for us, too?
I don't know. How's Edna doing, by the way?
Edna's doing good. She got a nice big Christmas present.
Oh, okay. What did you get? What did you get Edna this year?
Did you get her a new dress?
No, a new attitude.
A new attitude? Oh, my. Okay. All right. All right.
Well, I got her a new still, you know. She went to make some more moonshine.
Okay. All right. Well, we're going to let you go because there's somebody here in studio that I want to have a conversation with for about a minute or two before we get off the air. So
you got the police there again.
No. It's Dr. Tread from the Slim Body Laser Spa. He's in studio
maybe
with
Fredo
me.
Can get there with him then.
Well, yeah, maybe Fredo needs a little bit of help. Anyway, listen, I'll let you run, and I will talk to you soon, old man. You have a great day.
Okay, you guys have a good day.
All right, bye-bye now. So in studio with me, and this is kind of a little different, Dr. Tread, would you come right up to that microphone if you would? Because Dr. Tread is here in studio with us. He's here a little early. Good morning, Dr. Tread.
Good morning, Stuart, Florida. Good morning, Evan. And good morning, Bonnie.
Good morning, Dr. Tread.
Dr. Tread has a show that's on, if you probably don't already know, that's on from 9 to 10 every Tuesday. And I am actually one of Dr. And I'm proud to say that I am one of Dr. Tread's patients now. And I told him yesterday, and it makes me feel good, and I told you this, thanks to Dr. Tread, I've lost 3 inches on my belly.
Yay!
Hey, clap your hands, Evan.
Right? They don't have to widen the door anymore for when I come in here.
That was like trying to drain the swamp.
I know.
Evan's belly fat.
Sounds like you're a patient making progress now, not only a patient in progress.
I'm making process.
That's wonderful.
And the process is, it's really amazing.
I'm going to explain it in just a moment.
Yeah, in just a little bit, Dr.
In depth. I'm also going to go over a fitness guru, a healthcare guy who you're all going to know when I talk about him.
Okay,
we're
all right.
Feature him as our feature health fitness guru.
Oh, wow, that's exciting.
Of the year, yep.
That's exciting. But for those of you that are looking to lose inches on your belly or anywhere on your body, if you're looking to lose inches, honestly, I highly recommend you go over there because it works.
Yeah, take off all of that eggnog put on your belly during the holidays.
It works.
Eggnog, the cakes,
you
cookies.
Go in, you sign up, you get 9 sessions.
Yeah,
and the key is it doesn't work just by you go in and you get the laser. You have to also follow a guideline, Bonnie. There's a guideline of nutrition. There's a guideline of exercise. There's a guideline of eating the right foods. So you have to have all the pieces to the puzzle correctly lined up for this system to work.
So it's a very realistic way for nutrition and weight loss.
Yeah, it is. It is. And it's helped me. I've put pants on I haven't worn in forever.
Wow.
So it really feels good.
How long have you had those pants?
I've had those pants hanging in the closet for quite some time, trust me.
And you've gone now to Dr. Tread for how many weeks?
I've been going, I think I'm coming up on session number 7 or 8, or I'm not sure. I'm kind of getting to the tail end of things, but
nice.
his wonderful assistant that takes charge over there is Juan, and she is if you haven't met Juan yet, boy, let me tell you, that's a personality that needs no sunshine at all whatsoever.
That's great.
Yeah, it's a great experience. I highly suggest that you do give them a phone call and all that other good fun stuff as well.
Glad that you have more energy lately.
I feel better too. I really do.
If you can tell.
That's a wrap for the morning show. We're done. We're out of here. We're like yesterday's kitty litter. And as always, I always like to close the show with saying that if you have good values on the inside, always remember, you won't look for validation on the outside. Always remember that.
That's a good...
Always remember that.
Good invalidated right.
It's a true
Rightly
statement.
So.
We're WSTU Stewart, Martin County's Heritage Station, and we're WPSL, Port St. Lucie, the talk of the Treasure Coast. We will see everybody right back here tomorrow morning, Bonnie, right?
Mm-hmm.
Bright and early.
48 hours, or actually make that...
24.
20.
If you're doing 48, I won't see you tomorrow. Anyway, folks, have a great day. Slim Body Laser Spa coming up next.